should point out Ringens has been signed for the next big card here in town on Saturday, May the 21st at the University of Illinois Chicago Pavilion. No opponent named for Ringens. By the way, tickets also available in advance at all Ticketron locations in the greater Chicagoland area and at the Pavilion ticket office. In addition, Mike Graham out of Tampa, Florida, tremendous young athlete, will be defending the light heavyweight championship of the world against Spike Huber, and also rock and roll Buck Zumhoff signed on that big card. Bobby Heenan, you said for the past couple of weeks you've had something up your sleeve.
That's right.
Some cloud of secrecy.
A big surprise, but I'll get to that in a minute. First of all, I am tired of the phone calls from Stanley Blackburn, the AWA committee. I'm tired about hearing from Vern Gagne and everybody else about Jerry Lawler wants a rematch. Jerry Lawler demands a shot at Bockwinkel, and he deserves this, he deserves that. Lawler, you had your one opportunity and you blew it. Go back down to the bottom of the ladder and get in line. I'm tired of hearing about you. I'm tired of hearing about your demands and what you want. I talked to Andy Kaufman. Him and I had a big laugh at the thinking about Jerry Lawler at the back of the ladder looking up at everybody else. So as far as I'm concerned, Mr. Lawler, go back down to Tennessee where you belong and stay out of my business. Now, I'm going to get down to business here. I'm going to introduce in a minute a man out here that when he heard what happened to Duncombe, when he heard how the High Flyers deliberately came off the top rope and injured Duncombe's leg, he said one thing to me. He says, get me Gagne or get me Brunzell. I don't care. I want either one of them. And I'm going to bring this man out here right now. And promoter Vern Gagne and Wally Carbo and Stanley Blackburn and all the promoters all over the world, get this match on paper and get it here if you can. Because this man, none other, 6'5". 260 pounds, Black Jack Lanza. We want Greg Gagne or Brunzell's name on the dotted line now.
Can't believe it, out of Dallas, Texas, the return of Black Jack Lanza and the Texas Brainbuster.
Believe it, little man. I'll tell you one thing. Chicago's been one of my favorite towns in the whole wide world. But back in the history books a little bit, Gagne's out here talking about history. It was in Chicago that Duncombe and I won the championship, the tag team, the world tag team championship. Bruiser and the Crusher with their shoulders down. And there's no way in the world that two rugrats are going to get away with putting Duncombe down and putting them out of business. If you think you're going to get away with that, rugrats, sadly mistaken. You're going to have to face me sooner or later. Let's make it sooner, shall we?
Where have you been for the last 3 years, Black Jack Lanza?
Is any of your business, I'll tell you. But I've been around the world hurting people because I thoroughly enjoy hurting people. Whether they fight back or not makes no difference to me. Yeah. I get away with whatever I want.
I thank you.
As I come
much.
And walk and do whatever I want.
Hey, Mr. Lawler, why don't you try blackjack on for size?
Thank you,
you very much,
gentlemen. Stay tuned. We're going to get you back up into the ring. That action forthcoming.
Boy Adonis and Greg Gagne. Let's go to ringside for the action.
Greg has been working on the arm of Adrian Adonis throughout most of this match so far. Whether that is a move to try to set something else up, well, we'll have to watch and see. Adrian Adonis, of course, part of the East-West connection in Jesse the Body Ventura, that East-West connection. It's been a comparatively clean match so far.
Ron, that gives me that opening. It surprises me that Adrian, the Golden Boy, has been wrestling as cleanly as he has. But watch, he'll do something.
I think his mood and manner is about to change. He no doubt will be going to work here on the left leg of Greg Gagne now. Has to kick it out from under him. Greg hanging onto the ropes there in the corner with that left leg hammered into the turnbuckle. Greg is hurting, no doubt about it. But competitor that he is, I certainly look for him to fight his way out of this. Leg lock and a twist. You could hear Greg Gagne say, ouch, as that was put on. And again, we tell you that if you have designs on being a professional wrestler, make doggone sure that pain threshold of yours is very, very high, because you're going to need it. smart. He hurt. See where Adonis goes with it now. He'll twist it around again and drive it to the mat. Whether it's the knee or the thigh, both of them, I'm sure, not feeling too good right now for Greg Gagne. Out of the ring he goes. Adrian Adonis appealing to the fans for their support and backing. Of course, he gets none of that. Greg Gagne on the floor outside the ring. Will take as much time as he possibly can. Out comes Adonis after him. Body slam to the floor. Evan Johnson, the referee, warning Adonis about that. Any more of it, and he no doubt would be disqualified. Gagne on the floor. This is a 45-minute match. We heard ring announcer Al DeRuscia just say elapsed time, 10 minutes. The count starts again on Greg Gagne. Every time that Adonis comes over and Johnson, the referee, has to push him away, the count will resume. Out of the ring goes Adrian. Gagne is back in, but takes another kick from Adonis in the process, and he's wrapped up in the bottom and second rope. Ooh, ow. Adonis working on that left leg. Adonis thinks he has Gagne right where he wants him. And for all intents and purposes, about this very minute, he does. See what's going to happen here. Oh, the backbreaker. A cover by Adonis. One, two. Close.
That left leg of Greg's is in very bad shape, Rod.
And Adonis has been working on it for a long, long time, and it may be at a point now where Greg might not be able to recover. Adonis trying to work into the Boston Crab to work it over. Greg hanging in there. Adonis cannot turn him over. Not quite yet. And one thing Greg is not about to do, at least not yet.
Break him up.
About to say that Greg is not about to do is use the ropes for protection. Well, he was underneath them, and Adonis continued hammering away, and he continues to kick away at that bad left leg of Greg Gagne. Adrian Adonis strutting around the ring, motioning to somebody at ringside, hey, you come on up, I'll take care of you too. Evan Johnson.
He's getting very cocky right now, Rod, and I'll tell you one thing. He better not get overconfident because Greg Gagne is a competitor.
And he has that French temper, a la Vern Gagne.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
One thing you know for sure, he is not going to quit. Also, another thing you know for sure, because you can see it, that he is in pain. That left leg has taken a beating here for about the last 5-6 minutes. Adonis trying to get at him. And, of course, as long as Adonis does that, Johnson does not count. And Greg Gagne has an additional 10 seconds to recover, move around. I think you'll see him start to quicken the tempo here in just a little bit. To run off. Here he goes. He's picking it up just a little bit. And he'll be coming back into that ring not too far from now. He's shaking it off. And the crowd is helping him do it. Here he comes. Look out, Mr. Adonis. Hey! Oh, my! Oh! Off to the turnbuckle for Adrian Adonis. And Greg Gagne is upset beyond words.
Did the same thing.
Adonis now pleading for mercy, but getting none. Right hand. Over he goes and tied up in the ring rope. And Gagne going to work on him with a right and a left and a right. Adonis working himself free from the ropes. Gagne whips him off. Back body drop. Flying drop kick. One, two. The sleeper hold, is it time? Here it is. The sleeper hold put on by Greg Gagne. Adonis gets to the ropes, and over the top rope they both go. Referee has called this one. Hey. Oh, my.
All right, fans, you've just seen action from one of the great arenas of North America. Greg Gagne meeting Golden Boy Adrian Adonis. As I remind you, Chicago, big, big card coming up on Saturday, May the 21st, University of Illinois, Chicago, in the pavilion at Harrison and Racine. Signed thus far, you might want to jot these down. It is the makings of a tremendous card indeed. Rock and roll Buck Zumhoff to meet Steve Regal. Also sign of that card, Spike Huber, a favorite here in Chicago, to go against Mike Graham out of Tampa, Florida, for the light heavyweight championship of the world. Bobby Heenan with a shocker. I couldn't believe it. Blackjack Lanza back on the scene, part of the Bobby Heenan family, and vowing revenge for the injury that is now sidelined, Big Bad Bobby Duncombe. Here is a man I want to bring in. Originally from Algiers, as everybody knows, one of the veterans in professional wrestling, very volatile individual. I'm talking about Maurice Mad Dog Vachon.
First time I go to a university in my life, and I flunked my exams. Yes, I was going to go there and graduate from the University of Illinois in Chicago in the pavilion. A degree in destruction, not an engineer's degree, but a degree in destruction. I was going to destroy a name that I hate more than anything in the world, a name by the name of Fatwell. And it was you, Fatwell, and your partner in crime, the Sheik Adnan Casey, that did this to me. But I'm going to go back to the University of Illinois, Chicago, in the pavilion. If you're going to wrestle with me, 2-on-1, but one behind my back. I want to wrestle with both of them. Two of them on one. Wait. But at least I know where they'll be coming from. Right in front of me.
Well,
because they're two cowards, that's what they are.
Wait a minute. That is, I believe, Mad Dog Vachon, an unreasonable request. One man against two, simply unheard of.
If you think that the battle for the mayor of Chicago was a free-for-all between Washington, Ebtern, and Mayor Byrd, you haven't seen nothing. It's going to be a free-for-all. It's going to be, matter of fact, a battle royale when I put my hands on the Sheik and his partner in crime, Fatwell. I'm going to destroy them both.
Exactly what he has in mind, I don't know, ladies and gentlemen. Mad Dog Vachon, you heard him right here, asking for both the Sheik and Jerry Blackwell, one man against two. What Vern Gagne, promoter here in town, is going to be saying about that, what AWA officials will say, fans, I wouldn't even want to venture a guess. More action up in the ring following this. Seeing the incredible Hulk Hogan in action. By the way, Chicago, I remind you, we're back in town, big, big card, right here at the University of Illinois, Chicago, in the pavilion. And that date is Saturday, May the 21st, Saturday night, big, big card in the making. You know some of the top names already signed. Gentlemen, on the heels of conversation from Mad Dog Vachon, I just had to bring in Sheik Adnan El Casey, and especially you, Jerry Blackwell.
Well, let me tell you something. Every time he gets in the ring, it's pandemonium. He goes, he grabs chairs, he does anything. He bites, he claws, he scratches. He does anything he can do to destroy people. Well, Mr. Mad Dog Vachon, you got exactly what you deserve. And if you think for 1 minute that you're going to get in the ring and you're going to destroy both of us. You've got another thing coming. He should be somewhere behind bars. He should be in an insane asylum somewhere. He's a crazy man. And now it's really proved that he's a crazy man because he asked for Sheik Adnan El Casey and myself. 2-1. Well, you come on, Mr. Mad Dog Vachon. We accept.
Jerry Blackwell, let me ask you a question. Do you think the promoters, do you think the AWA and its governing body is going to let Mad Dog Vachon get in there alone with the two of you for a minute?
Is that what he asked for?
That's what he asked
for. He's a man. He's over 21. He knows what he's doing. I reckon he knows what he's doing. But Mad Dog Vachon, you come on and you get in the ring with both of us. And we'll remove that thorn from our side. We'll send you back to that coal mine, way down deep to the bottom. And you can find a slimy rock to crawl under. Because we'll finish you off once and for all. And then we can go ahead and do what we set out to do. And that's win the World Tag Team titles. Greg Gagne and Jim Bronzell, as far as I'm concerned, y'all nothing but two yellow-bellied cowards.
Well, gentlemen, I don't want to get into that. Sheik Adnan El Casey.
You know, Your Highness.
Please, not so loud.
Don't lose your temper, because this is what the American wants. Control your temper, Your Highness. We cannot afford to lose our temper. There is a saying in the Arab world, Mr. Gene Oakland. The caravan will continue her mission, and the barking of the dog will never stop the caravan. And our mission, Your Highness, is to capture the Tag Team Championship of the world. We must not let the dog stop us. We must not let the dog hurt us. Our mission is to capture the Tag Team Champion of the world.
Well, that is
better. Take a look, Your Highness.
Take a look.
This is what you're going to receive.
All part of the harem, Terry Blackwell.
Wait a minute. Can I ask you a question? When we win the world title, how many of them have?
As many as you want.
30.
Oh, as many as you want.
30.
No, yes, that's a big number. Can you believe that?
I can't.
Limousines.
Yes, indeed. More action results.
Come on.
Stay tuned. We're going to get you back
that's
up.
That's the way we want it.
Hey, put it away. Fans here in Chicago, before we close out the program for today, I want to confront World's Heavyweight Champion Nick Bockwinkel. For myself and nearly 10,000 people, I don't think there was any question of a doubt that you were truly in a battle when you met Jerry Lawler the last time out at the University of Illinois Chicago in the pavilion. I've got to confront you. Is there a chance? Your manager has said absolutely not. A chance of a rematch between Mr. Lawler and yourself.
Do you have a hearing problem?
I'd like to get it from...
No, I'm just asking you a question. Do you have a hearing problem?
Well, of course I don't.
Read our lips.
No.
All right, it's...
All right, the man told you earlier, and it's simply this. Now, many people are saying, because they seem to be captivated with Mr. Lawler, the little southern boy who came up north and decided to do his thing. Why, and I'll ask it to you simply... What great wrestling ability did he demonstrate that in the slightest way or fashion your simple minds would constitute that he deserved the opportunity for another shot at the heavyweight championship of the world? Now, of course, if that question confused you, that's understandable. No. As far as I am concerned,
Mr. Who initiated that slugfest, Nick Bockwinkel?
Who initiated it? First of all, this. That's legal. This is legal. This forearm is legal, whether it's here to the side of the head, wherever you want it. Those are all legal blows in the art of wrestling.
Oh, I didn't
see
you.
This is not legal.
That
isn't
legal.
That's not legal. And that's all Lawler did out there was throw punches. You want a box? Go pick on Larry Holmes or somebody. Don't come up in our face.
It is really sad that the simpletons seem to get behind this animal, because I'm not going to elevate him and compliment him anymore
than
that.
You know, he's like the people here in Chicago. They have a riddle going here.
Why don't
you know how to get 12 hillbillies from Tennessee into a Volkswagen? Tell them you're going to Chicago.
Chicago, we will see you next Sunday morning. Keep looking up, and so long, everybody. I can't believe that. Dean Brad Ringens in action. And hello again, Chicago. Gene Okerlund here, All-Star Wrestling. Is off and running. A tremendous card the last time out here in Chicago at the University of Illinois Chicago in the pavilion We had to turn a lot of folks away. We don't want that to happen to you. Ladies and gentlemen, by all means, get your tickets in advance for the next big card on Saturday night, May the 21st, 8:30 p.m., in the Pavilion, Harrison and Racine, on the campus of the University of Illinois in Chicago. Tickets available at the Pavilion box office and all Ticketron locations in the greater Chicagoland area. Top names signed include strongman Ken Patera, his opponent none other than Dick the Bruiser. Mad Dog Vachon has asked promoter Vern Gagne for the Sheik and Jerry Blackwell. Vachon saying he wants to take on these two men all by himself. World champion Nick Bockwinkel, Bobby Heenan, come on in. The big news this past week, when I found out that the rematch is set for the 21st of May, you Nick Bockwinkel, to go against Jerry Lawler. Myself, I was at ringside for the match. I talked to a lot of fans feeling that Lawler is deserving of a second opportunity, Bobby
Heenan.
Hey,
pal, I don't care what those fans think. I could care less what their wants and needs are. I'm going to ask you a question now. During that match, when I jumped up on the apron, did I touch Lawler in any way? Well, did I trip him? Did I do anything to him? He banged into me, didn't he? Didn't he?
Bobby Heenan.
Didn't he?
You interfered.
The reason I jumped up was because what does it say on the marquee? All-star
wrestling.
Right. Mm-hmm. How many punches did Lawler throw?
Please, may I at this point?
Help yourself.
The man is telling you the story. Now, it is amazing that the new promoter in Chicago and I have a past history. And it is sad and pathetic because he always represented wrestling. This is what he told you over the years. Yet here is a man in the name of Jerry Lawler who demonstrated absolutely zilch wrestling ability in that match. How can I say that? No, you see, you've got one of those small humanoid cretinous minds like all those people out there. And the problem you have is the one that they have. It simply amounts to this. You all got turned on by the punches he threw, by the Duke City. The name of the game is wrestling, not boxing. I'll admit one thing. You throw one hell of a punch, Lawler. You can bust somebody up alongside the head with your fist real well. But then what has ever happened to the sport of wrestling? This is a sad and pathetic day that they have seen fit to put this kind of a man back in a position.
You know what it is? It's the people's like the Gagnas and Stanley Blackburns that want to see you dethroned. They want to see you beat. They don't care if a man punches. They don't care if a man kicks. And then I merely jump on the apron to inform the referee that the man is punching. And the man, he runs into me. He loses a match. They say he held the rope and then blame us.
Gentlemen, like it or not, Nick Bockwinkel, you've got a title defense. And Jerry Lawler is going to be the challenger, part of the great card here on the 21st of May at the Pavilion at the University of Illinois, Chicago. Zell, back in the fold, the Bobby Heenan family, the veteran Blackjack Lanza, the big man out of Texas.
That's right, Gene. I'm sure the people remember last week Blackjack Lanza came out here and threatened both myself and my partner, Greg Gagne.
Called you Rugrats.
That's right.
Recall.
You know, I know he's got some concern and some thought in the back of his mind about one Bobby Duncombe, but I just want to say this, Blackjack Lanza. Now you have an opportunity to let your actions speak louder than your words. You know, you haven't been wrestling that I know of or anybody else that I know of in the last 4 or 5 years.
Well, but he has been. In fact, we find out, Jim.
Okay, I know all about Jack Lanza. I know that he's a very, very tough opponent. He gets a lot of thrill out of inflicting pain, and he will do anything to win. And I know right now he's got a lot of extra incentive because if he can get a victory over me, it would enable him and maybe Patera to get a championship match. Jack Lanza, I'll be ready for you.
All right, Blackjack Lanza, to meet this man, jumping Jimmy Bronzell. We're going to get you back up into the ring. Stay tuned, everybody.
Thank you, Jim.
Rock and roll Buck Zumhoff in action. We're going to get you back up into the ring for the second of the best 2 out of 3 falls here on All-Star Wrestling. Chicago, I was in town the last time out for that big card at the University of Illinois Chicago in the Pavilion. What a fantastic facility. There is not a bad seat in the house, as they say. Get your tickets in advance for the next big super card coming up on the 21st of May, 8:30 p.m. in the Pavilion, Harrison and Racine. And tickets, by the way, available at the Pavilion box office as well as all Ticketron locations in the greater Chicagoland area. Maurice Mad Dog Vachon, I want you to come on in if you would, please. Mad Dog, you signed a contract to meet the Sheik and Jerry Blackwell. the promoters, AWA officials, not going along with letting you get in the ring by yourself to meet these two men. Oh, you've got to have
a partner. No, they're not going along because now I have a chance to put my head on Fatwell and the Sheik all by myself to go a day in the ring in the pavilion and to give it to them what they have coming. Fatwell, you're not going to get away with what you did to me. You and the Sheik, two on one, but one behind my back with the cast. This is the kind of a man you are, Fatwell. You're yellow, but alone you cannot do it. So do it two on one. Make it two against one. I'll take you both out, you yellows.
Just a second here. Mad Dog Vachon, I can certainly empathize with you. You recall, I was at ringside. I saw exactly what happened. Nonetheless, the fact remains, you will have to have a partner.
Never! I don't need a partner. You mind your business.
Don't you touch. Just a second. Mad Dog Vachon, you're not choosing a partner, so the AWA has appointed a partner for you to meet the two Sheiks.
I don't need no appointment from nobody.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, Mad Dog Vachon. The man is right here, I believe.
Where?
I think you are going to be pleasantly surprised when you find out that here he is, Clawmaster Baron Von Reske.
The glow. Oh, that's a different story, the Baron.
Well, look at the delight of Mad Dog Vachon.
Baron, that's a different story.
A different story indeed, Baron Von Reske.
I was never so happy with the AWA when they came to me and said, Mad Dog must have a partner, and they appointed me. I was never more happy. Mad Dog and the Baron together again against the Sheiks, Blackwell and Casey. Well, this time, Mad Dog won't have to watch his back, because I'll be there. That's all the beginning.
It's a different story,
it's
right?
It's a different story. It's going to be a dog-eat-dog story.
Well, I thought Mad Dog Vachon pleasantly surprised at the appointment of Baron Von Reske to be his partner when they meet the Sheik. All right, fans, a lot more action coming up here on All-Star Wrestling. Special congratulations, especially in the playoffs. What a tremendous effort on the part of the Chicago Blackhawks. Tremendous coach in Orville Tessier, the names of Secord, and so many other great, great names on that Chicago Blackhawks team. The very best of luck to them. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, tremendous card back in Chicago. We're here in town at the Pavilion, the University of Illinois Chicago, Saturday night, May the 21st, 8:30 p.m. Tickets available, by the way, at the Pavilion box office and also at Ticketron locations in the greater Chicagoland area. I repeat, Jerry Lawler, King Jerry Lawler, getting a rematch, and I think the consensus of fans, myself and many who were at the Pavilion for the last big card, Lawler deserving another shot at Nick Bockwinkel and the world's heavyweight title. Rick Martel to meet Jesse the Body Ventura, Dick the Bruiser, longtime favorite here in Chicago, to go against Ken Patera, jumping Jimmy Brunzel to meet Blackjack Lanza, Steve Regal out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida, to meet Rock and Roll Buck Zumhoff, and, as you heard earlier, Mad Dog Vachon refusing to choose a partner on his own. The AWA, along with promoter Vern Gagne, matchmakers in town, appointing a partner for Vachon of the form of Clawmaster Baron Von Reske. Sheik, Jerry Blackwell, gentlemen, I'm certain that is somewhat of a surprise to you. Where is the Sheik, Jerry Blackwell?
You know where the Sheik is, and why are you asking me? And you know the reason he's not here, too.
I think these people probably are entitled to an explanation.
It's none of their business.
What about Baron Von Reske? Is that a shocker?
Yeah, that's a shocker. Because Mad Dog Vachon, as far as I'm concerned, you're nothing but a barefaced liar. You come out and you raved and you rapped and you wanted the Sheik and myself by yourself. But you had it planned all the time with AWA officials. It's just another typical American trick to try to destroy the team, to try to prevent us from becoming world tag team champions. Well, let me tell you something. You've got a maniac on your side, and you're a maniac yourself. Y'all both should be in some insane asylum somewhere. Y'all should be in straitjackets. Y'all shouldn't be able to walk up and down the streets.
But I'm going to remove this thorn from my side once and for all. Because I'm going to come in that ring. And it's going to be a dogfight. It's going to be an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. Because if you pick up a chair, I'm going to pick up a chair. If you pick up a bell, I'm going to pick up a bell. And when I walk away, if you think the 2.5 years you laid on the shelf, Mad Dog Vachon, was a lot of pain and suffering, it's going to be nothing to what I do to you. And Baron Von Raske, I know you've got the claw, but what are you going to do when you have a bunch of broken fingers?
What about the Sheik, Jerry Button?
Shut up! Don't ask me again!
We will be right back. Tremendous turnaway crowd the last time out at the Pavilion here in Chicago. I was there. It is a new era in professional wrestling. Vern Gagne right now promoting here in Chicago, working with matchmakers and AWA officials, Jesse Ventura. I just had to compliment earlier the Chicago Blackhawks, Orville Tessier, the names of Savard, Preston, Secord, Bannerman, Lysiak, Esposito, all of them. Just a tremendous effort. They're winners.
Oh, yeah. You know what I'd like to do right now? You know, Secord is supposed to be the tough guy of Chicago, right? Mr. Badness. Secord, anytime you want to find out how tough you really are, Jesse the Body's waiting for you.
Wait a minute, Jesse Vent, are you aware of the fact that you are missing a lens from your sunglasses?
Yeah, I'm aware of it. You know what that's for?
I have
that's
no...
to keep an eye on you.
Oh, for crying. Jesse Ventura, let's get down to professional wrestling. This brilliant young star out of the province of Quebec, Rick Martel, your opponent here on the 21st of May.
Yeah. You know, Rick Martel, he's a gifted athlete. But Rick Martel has one thing wrong with him. Rick Martel, you're too pretty to be in professional wrestling. You know, you got those pearly white teeth. You're considered the top bachelor.
Most eligible
bachelor. Most eligible bachelor.
That's what they say.
Well, Rick Martel, between now and when you step into the ring with me, I got a strong suggestion for you, boy. And that is this. You better go out and get married. And get married quick. Because when I'm done with you, Rick Martel, ain't gonna be no woman in Chicago, none up in Canada, or none across the world that gonna wanna look at you anymore. Because like I said, Martel, you're too pretty to be in wrestling. So I'm gonna make you a little bit more ugly. You know, I'm gonna thoroughly enjoy it, Mean Gene, taking Martel and introducing his beautiful face to a turnbuckle. What a meeting that's gonna be.
Well,
Martel,
well,
you can announce your engagement to a turnbuckle.
Don't.
When our match is over. And you know, one other quick note, I'm done with you for now, Martel. I understand your kid is the property of the New York Islanders. Well, I guess there goes a destiny down the drain, huh?
You have won. We'll have won.
I'll tell you, at the Billy Goat Tavern and Saloon, they're talking about this young man,
Steve Regal. You know, Steve Regal, I haven't got any choice. I got to beat you because I'm after Mike Graham, the light heavyweight champion, or whoever wins between Hubert and him. Who's got the junior, who's got the light heavyweight championship belt, brother? That's the belt that I'm after, right?
Okay, thank you, Buxom Hall fans. More exciting action here on All Star.
What I like.
Talk to matchmakers and the AWA Championship Committee. I'm here to tell you another match added to that big May 21st card at the University of Illinois Chicago Pavilion for the light heavyweight championship of the world. It is going to be Spike Huber, very, very popular here in the greater Chicagoland area, challenging the current light heavyweight champion, Mike Graham, out of Tampa, Florida. Another big match on another big card. Bobby Heenan, the family, Jack Lanza, you know, Black Jack Lanza, back in the fold.
You know something, last time out here, I asked, when I introduced Black Jack Lanza, and I made the announcement that he was back, I asked for either of the high flyers, Gagne or Brunzel. Preferably Gagne, because he's the one that came off that top rope. But you notice he's not man enough to put his name on the card. He sent the upstairs maid, Jim Brunzel, to do his dirty work. Well, that's fine with Black Jack Lanza and myself, because eventually we'll get our hands on both of them for what they did to Bobby Duncombe.
All right, back in the AWA, and a busy, busy man over the past 4 or 5 years, Blackjack Lanza, all of a sudden, the talented high flyer Jim Brunzell.
High flyer Jim Brunzell, not talented by any means, a stretch of the imagination. Gagne, where are you? What'd you do, pick straws, and you won, so you got out. Okay, Brunzell, you're out here shooting your mouth off a minute ago, saying you wonder where I was. Well, you're going to just find out where I've been. You know, I've created a lot of enemies in this business for one reason only, because I like to hurt people. Nobody likes to get in the ring with me because I hurt people. I thoroughly enjoy hurting people. And you know what? You're going to find out just how bad I am.
All right. Blackjack Lanza going to be returning to Chicago on the 21st of May. Ken Patera, you talk about one of the tough guys in this great sport. You've got to talk about Dick the Bruiser.
I thought you were going to say Mr. Lanza here. It's like a breath of fresh air to see you back, Jack.
Thank you, Ken.
I'll tell you, it's beautiful. I'll tell you, Mr. Who'd you say?
Dick the Bruiser.
That's what I thought you said. Well, his son-in-law, Spike Huber, is going to be on the card. I'm going to tell you something, Spike. I don't want you to get real worn out by your match, because when it's all over, you're going to have to be down at ringside in order to help your father-in-law out of the ring. And that's none other than Dick the Bruiser, one of the toughest, one of the meanest, and they call him the most dangerous man in professional wrestling. You know why? Because he's so stupid and crazy, and he doesn't even know what he's going to do from minute to minute. I might turn my back and get hit with a chair. I might be down the mat. He might hit me with whatever.
But don't worry. With that swinging neck breaker, it's going to be curtains for Dick the Bruiser. But he'll still be able to find something to do in life. Maybe you've read the papers about Hervé Villechaize on Fantasy Island.
Yeah,
well, he refused to sign his contract.
Right.
Bruiser can get his job. He can be the new midget on Fantasy Island.
You've got to be kidding me. Dane Jump and Jimmy Bronze out in action. Hello again, Chicago. Here we go. All-Star Wrestling on the air. Interviews you're seeing this morning, pre-recorded before the big card at the University of Illinois Chicago Circle in the pavilion last night. Bobby Heenan, many people questioning the decision with that big financial agreement that was consummated last week in front of a national television audience. Many saying you were short-sighted because now all of a sudden you are left without a tag team.
My naive little man. I may look like I'm left without a tag team. That week I had to contemplate receiving $250,000. The light bulbs were flashing in my head. I had ideas. I got plans. I'm way ahead of everybody else in professional wrestling.
Sure about it.
I'm not like you. I don't tell everything I know. That's why I'm the brain. That's why I can pull off these multi-million dollar deals. That's why I'm the manager of the heavyweight champion of the world. And I have plans down the road. You can bet on that. And if the high flyers think they have that I've forgotten about them, if they think I've forgotten about going for the World's Tag Team Championship or even getting my hands on Greg Gagne, you know, in a six-man tag here, Gagne drop-kicked me in the back and knocked me into Hulk Hogan. Now, sure, that's fine from behind. They're always accusing me of everything from behind. You know, Gagne is not man enough to do anything face-to-face to me. He wouldn't even get in a match with me. He had to hide behind Brunzell and Hogan. He's not man enough. He's the biggest yellow coward I've ever seen in professional wrestling. But now that I've got my $250,000, you can bet one thing. My mind's going to be clicking like this, and I'm going to come up with a lot more surprises.
All right, Bobby Heenan. You heard what he had to say. Gentlemen, come on in. Greg Gagne, Jim Brunzell.
Did we hear him right?
I believe we did.
He wants part of me?
I'll tell you, as far as I'm concerned,
if the promoters or the matchmakers want to put that match together, myself and Bobby Heenan, I'd be more than glad to step in the ring with him. We don't have to do anything from behind. We don't have to do any under-the-table money passing or attacking our opponents from behind, Mr. Heenan. So if you want to step in and settle it or create it or whatever, you and I in a match, that's fine with me.
All right. Now, Jim Brunzell, you are side against the veteran, Golden Greek John Tolis, here at the Pavilion, University of Illinois, Chicago. The next date, by the way, is Saturday, June the 18th.
That's right, Gene. John Tolis is a veteran wrestler. He's been around a number of years. He's got a lot of experience. He knows every trick in the book, and he'd like nothing more than to get in the ring with me and upset me. So I know when I get in the ring, in any match I've ever had in the AWA, you can't take anything for granted, because the minute you do, you're going to fall right on your backside and get beat.
You know, Gene, Heenan said something about a tag team, that he had something in the back of his mind. Well, Mr. Heenan, no matter who you bring in, and as far as we're concerned with Blackwell and Patera, they're going to have to earn a shot at the High Flyers, and the AWA, I hope, feels the same way about it. And Heenan, I don't think you can surprise us with anything. So if he's got a team in mind, bring him on. But let's Heenan, you and I step in the ring first.
All right. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Greg Gagne, Jim Bronzell, they are currently the tag team champions of the world. More action up in the ring in just a moment.
$50 into his back pocket, he made a very wise and shrewd business deal. It's that simple. What?
Is he going to be in your corner next Saturday night? That's the question.
Bobby Heenan will be in my corner. Now, maybe other people sold their interest out here, there, or whatever, but Mr. Heenan will be at my side, Mr. Lawler. Now, I have reiterated this a number of times. You do not deserve a shot at the heavyweight championship of the world again, but you've gotten it. And you've gotten it simply because the greatness of myself, the success of Mr. Heenan, and I would imagine this extra $250,000 he's stuck in his pocket is just really making other people boil. And if it makes you incensed and inspired a little bit more, that you want to try a little bit harder to capture the heavyweight championship of the world from me, that's just good. I have not lost my fight. I have not lost my desire. I have not gotten bored with being the heavyweight champion of the world. I enjoy it. I enjoy everything that's up there. So that if I have to get into this ring and learn how to fight your style, if I have to punch my way through something in order to become a great wrestling champion, now what is this? Am I to be insulted by such trash?
I am sorry, Nick Bockwinkel.
Get that traitor out of here. You know, I want to say something about Ken Patera and the Weasel. You know, Gino, at one time, Ken Patera, he saluted the flag at the Olympics. He lifted weights at the Olympics. He didn't get a dime for it. He had respect for America. Now that she comes along, puts this money under his nose, the Weasel's nose. Give me one shot at those traitors. That Weasel, I'm going to have to get him in the ring. That burns me up the more I think about it, brother.
Well,
I know I got big matches coming up, but this stuff's
indeed
on my mind, brother.
You do indeed.
The time's going to come, Weasel. I'm going to take that money.
Thank you. Rock and roll, Bucks Omaha fans, stay tuned. We're going to be back up into the ring momentarily. Thank you, Buck. I appreciate it. Fans, you've just seen World's Heavyweight Champion Nick Bockwinkel in action. I want to remind you again this morning, Chicago, the interviews you are seeing at this time here on All-Star Wrestling, recorded earlier in the week, prior to the big card at the Pavilion, the University of Illinois, Chicago, that would have taken place last night. The next big date, by the way, and I should remind you, it's going to be Saturday, June the 18th, and again, we're back at the Pavilion, University of Illinois, Chicago Circle, Harrison and Racine. Promoter Vern Gagne working on a big one. Tickets available in advance at the box office and at all Ticketron locations in the greater Chicagoland area. By the way, a couple of matches that have already been added to that card. Rocky Stone out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, to go against Canadian great, the popular Rick Martel. And Yugoslavian Chris Markov will be here in Chicago to go against former United States Olympic great Brad Ringens. Gentlemen, I wanted to bring you in at this time. Sheik Adnan El Casey, the deal that you pulled off here over the past couple of weeks, the talk of professional sports, aligning Ken Patera with Jerry Black. Well, now, gentlemen, we know, as the people watch this particular interview, that no conclusions have been reached because this is being recorded earlier in the week. I don't even want to discuss what might have happened, Jerry
Black. Let me tell you something I do. You just don't worry about what we're discussing. First of all, Mad Dog Vachon, you and Vern Gagne broke my partner's arm, and you thought, Vern Gagne, you had prevented us from becoming world champions. You thought, hey, you had protected your son, but you didn't. And my new partner and myself had to get in the ring with Mad Dog Vachon and Baron Von Raske. And by now, we have eliminated him. We have finished him, and we're going to step on to bigger and better things. And let me tell you one other thing, Vern Gagne. You stick to your job, and that's negotiating contracts to have wrestling matches here. You keep your nose out of my business, and you keep from running in the ring on me.
All right. Thank you, Jerry Black. Well, Sheik Adnan El Casey, a well-known fact, you are now totally out of the picture as far as wrestling is concerned.
You know, they re-broke my hand, Mr. Gene Oakland, and they thought the team of the Sheik is no longer exist, but we smarted them. We have
outsmarted them, Sheik?
Absolute. Now, here's the strongest wrestlers in the world and the biggest wrestlers in the world. How can you lose? This means the whole $800 million Arab world today they're talking about. Even Gaddafi of Libya, King Hussein of Jordan, King Fahd of Saudi Arabia. They said your mission is to accomplish the tag team champion of the world.
All right, Ken Patera, quickly your thoughts.
Everybody thinks that I sold out. Of course I sold out to the Arabs for $250,000, wouldn't you? And that's just the tip of the iceberg. The next is going to be the tag team championships of the world.
And you see, Baghdad Red, all the riches, the herrings, the wealth.
Main Clawmaster, Baron Von Raschke in action. Oh, special hello to one of the great broadcasters here in Chicago, longtime friend of mine, Larry Lujack, man who watches All-Star Wrestling on a consistent basis. Come on in. Rick Martel, the interviews, the fans are seen at this time, pre-recorded before the big card last night at the Pavilion. You're signed June the 18th to go against Rocky Stone out of southern Louisiana.
Well, Gene, if people don't mind, I'd rather express myself in my native language, French.
S'il vous plaît.
Je dois dire à tout le monde que j'ai eu un but dans ma vie, c'est de devenir champion du monde. Ça fait 10 ans que je fais de la lutte, puis je vous promets une chose. Que je suis préparé, je suis prêt présentement. Tout ce que j'attends, c'est l'opportunité, la chance d'avoir un combat de championnat. C'est tout ce que j'attends. Puis je suis prêt, je m'entraîne très, très fort. J'espère que j'ai tout donné le support que j'ai besoin parce que je m'entraîne. Puis comme j'ai dit, j'espère que dans le futur, je vais avoir un combat de championnat. Puis je vous garantis une chose, je ne manquerai pas l'occasion. Je vais sortir de là en nouveau champion du monde.
Merci beaucoup. I thank you very much, Rick Martel, out of Quebec City, a former hockey player. One of the great goalies, he played junior A hockey up in that province. Jesse Ventura.
You want to talk about hockey, Mean Gene?
I love to talk the game.
Let me tell you something. Your good buddy, Orville Tessier, old Nikita Khrushchev himself of the 1980s, what's he doing now? I'll bet you the dude's playing plenty of golf.
Let me tell you something, Jesse Ventura. You do not build an entire franchise or rebuild an entire franchise in a matter of a year or two. It's going to take time, but I'll tell you, Chicago will be heard of. The Blackhawks are going to be a big number next year.
You build a franchise by getting somebody like me. I am a franchise. Everything I do. You know, let's take a look at Chicago athletics lately. Not looking too good for you, Chi-Town. They fork out millions of bucks to get Bannister from Seattle baseball, right? What's he won? One game?
Well, now, come on, Jesse.
The Blackhawks go down in four. George Allen, you're hurting. You bought part of this ball club. You better sell out while the stock's still good, Jack. But now let's get on to something else.
Wait a minute. Jesse Ventura, you think by knocking the great sports teams and the great fans of Chicago that you're accomplishing anything? Please. We're here to talk. Let's get on.
Yeah, let's talk wrestling. Imposing. Now, you know, last time in Chicago, Frenchie himself, Ricky Martel. Ricky Martel, as you know, these interviews are pre-recorded, so you ain't gonna be looking too good, and I highly doubt if you're ever gonna talk much French again. And I guarantee you one thing, pretty boy Rick Martel, I hope you took my advice and got yourself married, because you're gonna look awful funny. Can you see Frenchie with no front teeth? Tessier will sign him up. He won't need a mouth guard.
Well, thank you very much, Jesse Ventura.
Check out the lateral deltoid.
Fans, we're going to get you back up in the ring.
The connection to the tricep.
Now, what is this again? That's rock and roll Buck Zumhoff in action. Again, I repeat, the interviews you are seeing at this time, pre-recorded before the matches this past weekend. There's a young gentleman out of Tampa, Florida, who at the time that I am conducting this interview is the light heavyweight champion of the world. His name is Mike Graham. He has held that title for well over 3 years. This past week, he had some comments regarding competition in the AWA. Let's listen to Mike Graham.
I've wrestled all over the country, and right now there are a few people, Buck Zumhoff being one of them, little Greggy Gagne, who hides behind his dad all the time, or has his partner Jimmy Brunzel to watch his back. Both of those are a good pair together. Then, of course, you've got the the magnificent Hulk Hogan. When Hulk Hogan lays down, he's no wider than I am. Hogan, you're a big man, but I've got your number, and I've got everybody else's number, too. In Florida, where I come from, a man is a man. A man dresses like a man. He doesn't wear fancy outfits like Buck Zumoff. He doesn't wear his hair long like Hulk Hogan. He doesn't have little skinny arms like Greggy Gagne. You go to the gym and train. You dedicate yourself to your profession, and that's exactly what I've done. I won my first medal in amateur wrestling in 1960. Gagne, Brunzel, Hogan, Zumoff, what were you guys doing in 1960? You better start thinking twice when Mike Graham comes in town, because I'm a very serious person. I don't go out to bars and drink. I get 10 hours of sleep a night. I spend 3 hours a day every day in the gym lifting. I run. I play racquetball. I am a professional wrestler. My life is wrestling, and I'm going to come and prove that to everyone in North America.
At the time we are conducting this interview, Mike Graham is the light heavyweight champion of the world. He's out of Tampa, Florida, and he is a very outspoken young man. Rock and roll, Buck Zumoff. Come on in.
Zeno, I was just watching that in the monitor in the back, and he's talking about what a man should wear, what kind of clothes is going to make me a better man today. He's got a little earring in his ear, and he's talking about working out. And in 1960, he got some kind of a medal, some kind of a trophy for what? Driving a bicycle in 1960, or maybe a tricycle? And you talk about working out, brother? I've been in athletes, and I've been in sports all my life. And I want that title, and I want that belt. And you talk about being serious? Well, brother, I'm as serious as I'm ever going to be. So when I get you in the ring, Graham, we're going to put that belt around this guy's waist, baby.
All right.
And I'm going to teach him a little rock and roll, baby.
All right, thank you. Rock and roll, Buck Zumoff. A lot more exciting action is coming up in just a moment. Stay tuned.
All right. Off and running. Second ball coming your way. And Heenan hasn't let up. He is still steam. He was steam in the beginning when Jake Milliman got in the ring without a partner. Wally Carbo came and told the referee, Milliman has to have a partner. He assigned Wahoo McDaniel to take the place of Milliman's missing partner, and Wahoo McDaniel just pinned Blackjack Lanza. And they just tried to fool the referee on a tag offer, and of course, the referee didn't buy it. Heenan tried to decoy him again. And the men who finish one fall must start the next fall in a consecutive fall match. Whether it's 2 out of 3, 5 out of 10, I've never heard anything like that, anything past 2 out of 3. But just to make my point, side headlock, Wahoo McDaniel, former All-American Oklahoma University, professional football player in 4 teams in the NFL, the Jets, the Dallas Cowboys, and a couple of others. Can't think of them at the moment. Side headlock, and there's a tag off. Look at this. Wahoo McDaniel picking up on a side headlock on Jesse the Body right away. And shoulder block by Wahoo. He may have him. Nope, he didn't go for the pin. Daniel's still trying to get the birds from keep him from singing in his belfry. Oh, Heenan is just absolutely irate. He is absolutely bananas. He is really steamed. He's steamed primarily. Sure, they lost the first fall, but he's steamed because it's Wahoo McDaniel in there. Jake Milliman with a headlock on Ventura. And here's a good shot, and look, can you see that flagrant choke? The referee stops the count, and Ventura broke it. And look, there's the boot. Milliman, head rammed right in there, the tag off, and look, now here's Lanza. As he goes after Milliman again, an Irish whip in the rope, one in the guts. A kick in the back of the head, a tag off to Ventura. And in the guts for Milliman again. Milliman would love to tag off, I think. So would Wahoo McDaniel like to get him out. One, two, and he could have pinned him. I don't know why he didn't pin him, and he must have dished out some more punishment. An atomic drop bombed away. And a cover, one, two. Heenan, oh, that's why. You saw Heenan raise his hand. He says, pick him up. They tagged off. He wanted to turn him over to Lanza. A cover by Lanza, and two, and says, pick him up. Well, I'll tell you that Wahoo McDaniel almost came in on that one in their cover now. One, he picked him up. Instructions from Heenan, pick him up. Body slammer back, no body slam. Oh, here comes the brainbuster. And Lanza putting a brainbuster on Milliman. And the referee says, all right, I rang the bell. What else do you want? He rang it, but nobody's paying any attention to it. Hang on to your socks. Jesse, the body in here. Wahoo, going to work on him. Tomahawk the back of the neck, and Wahoo McDaniel after Lanza. Heenan is the protesting. And Wahoo McDaniel has Heenan from behind Lanza. Lanza working on him. Here comes Heenan. Oh, he's digging in his pocket. A foreign object he's got. There's the brass knuckles, and he goes right after. Goes right after Wahoo McDaniel. Over in this corner, Heenan putting it right back in his pocket. The referee didn't see it. Oh, I'll tell you now. After Wahoo is bleeding, they really nailed him. Here comes Rocky Stone. Here comes Jimmy Doo. Jesse, the body, throws Stone out. Lanza throws Jimmy Doo out. Wahoo McDaniel, bleeding profusely. Here comes the Baron. The Baron, the Clawmaster, goes after Lanza, after Ventura. Go off, I'll tell you. And now, Wahoo McDaniel's ready to go after Bobby the Weasel Heenan. Heenan bails out, gets back in. McDaniel catches him. Tears it. Apparently, Heenan's clothes right off his body. The Baron brings Ventura, chases him out of the ring area. Whoa, McDaniel has Heenan. He nailed him. They're nothing. They can't get Wahoo McDaniel off Heenan. This bell I've got doesn't make any difference at all. Heenan's clothes are in shreds. Heenan's in shreds. He's bleeding. I don't know if it's McDaniel's blood or Heenan's own. But brother, Lanza goes over to protect Heenan from McDaniel. Wally Carbo's in that ring, tries to slow down McDaniel. Boy, oh boy. He is absolutely. Now Heenan is bleeding himself, I think. Wahoo McDaniel opened up a cut on Heenan. They're taking Heenan out. Here's a shot of Bobby Heenan being taken out and helped and assisted by Blackjack Lanza in the ring. Wahoo McDaniel still wants to go. He wants more. In the center of that ring is part of Bobby the Brain Heenan's coat and part of his body. Wahoo McDaniel really went to work on Ventura. And Blackjack Lanza, here's a not too nice a shot of Wahoo McDaniel, but you can see that he too is seriously injured. He's obviously going to have some stitches. Boy, oh boy.
Ladies and gentlemen, I can't believe
hell is going on here. Now, I'm back in the dressing room, and what do I see? I see nothing but
Jack Lanza. You have got to be kidding me, Nick Bockwinkel.
I'll tell you what I see. I see my manager, Bobby Heenan, being drugged back with his head cut off, bleeding profusely like a damn pig. And I asked somebody, and they tell me Wahoo McDaniels is the man who
you
has
just
decided.
Wait a minute, Nick
wait,
Lockwood.
I'm not here to argue with anybody. I'm here to tell you one thing, and I'm here to tell you something, McDaniels. When I get the full details, it's going to come down simple. One stinking way. You do not take liberties with my manager. You do not have the audacity to take and put your hands on him to do what you just did to him. You have now incurred the wrath of not only Mr.
Let's
Heenan,
get the, full...
the entire Heenan family, the world's heavyweight champion, Lanza, and everybody else that belongs to us.
Nick Bockwinkel, let's deal with facts here. Just a second. Jesse Ventura, Blackjack Lanza, blatantly held Wahoo McDaniel.
The little tidbit that I could pick up is that Wahoo McDaniel stuck his nose into where
they want to come in here. Nobody does this. We weren't signed to wrestle Wahoo McDaniel. Look at the blood. Don't ever tell me Wahoo McDaniel's. He's nuts. Any man that come out and deliberately do this to Bobby Heenan is going to pay for it. Believe me. Nobody's going to do that to Heenan.
Gentlemen,
nobody!
You are looking at why
you're going to pay dearly for this.
I wouldn't be a bit surprised if we saw a suspension.
The Heenan family. No way!
There
look
should
at
be
this.
Only one suspension.
Gentlemen,
Wahoo
look
McDaniel.
At that blood.
He's the man who should be suspended.
I am trying to conduct an interview
here. We're
going to
step into the ring.
In the middle of
and when we do, I want you to know
turmoil.
One thing. All hell is going to break
blood.
Loose.
Don't.
If I have to take you off from the head
anybody,
to your toes,
forget
break
it.
You,
that's
or whatever it. It is.
Enough.
No
for,
way. I'm telling
no.
you right
get
now.
Get out of here.
You better get it straight.
No.
A more exciting action. They're calling it a new era in all-star wrestling. As everybody knows, we've had absolutely gangbusters, powerful crowds at the University of Illinois Chicago Circle in the pavilion. It's a great facility, not a bad seat in the house, I must say. And the next big date promoter Vern Gagne is working on is Saturday night, June the 18th, 8:30 p.m. in the pavilion, Harrison and Racine. Ladies and gentlemen, do get your tickets in advance. The interviews you are seeing at this time, pre-recorded before the matches this past weekend, I want to bring these gentlemen in. Clawmaster, Baron Von Raschke, we saw him in action earlier in this program, and of course the legendary Mad Dog Vachon.
Would you like to live in the Middle East? Every day you open the paper, you look at what's happening over there. The war between Baghdad, Iraq, and Iran. In Lebanon, bombing every day. King Faisal gets shot by his nephew. Colonel Gaddafi in Libya. Because there's uproar, greed. Every day you see an uprising, a shooting, because somebody wants it all. It's greed. You know, I was born in Algeria, and I remember it well when I had to dig out of a garbage can just to survive. And when I see fat slob like Blackwell walking down the street when other people are starving to death. I'll never forget that. And now you take a man like Patera, a man that represented this country to the Olympics, and now he sells his soul for $250,000. People will do anything for money because of greed, and now they want the tag team championship of the world. Well, I got news for you, my friend. As long as men like the Baron von Raschke and the Mad Dog, as long as we're around, they will never get the championship of the world. Never. This is a promise, my friend. This is a promise.
Maurice, you know, I listened to you, the way you describe things very vividly. Truly, what you have mentioned, a travesty. Baron von Raschke.
Das ist richtig. Mad Dog said it. Men like him and me, with our backgrounds, we learn to appreciate the United States from America. We can't be bought and bought.
Whatever.
But I tell you this, Patera, Blackwell, if there is still a team left by the time the people see this, Mad Dog and the Baron want to be the first to challenge you. We still have revenge in our heart. We can't be bought. And I tell you this, if we get in the ring with you, your team isn't going to last very long, no matter how many petrodollar sheiks put into it. That is all you need to know.
Just about lost my microphone. Fans, Mad Dog Vachon, Baron von Raschke, and we've got more action coming up in a moment. Chicago, we're off and running with All-Star Wrestling, the big one. Coming up Saturday night, June the 18th. And we're going to be at the University of Illinois here in Chicago at the Pavilion, Harrison and Racine. A quick 5 minutes from the loop. Plenty of tremendous, good, accessible parking. Tickets available in advance. We've had great crowds, so I strongly encourage you fans, get those tickets in advance. Greg Gagne, I find out now to go against Bobby the Brain Heenan. More on that later. One thing that has been set by promoter Vern Gagne for Chicago on the 18th, Bonkwinkle, Lanza, Ventura, to meet the trio of Wahoo McDaniel, King Jerry Lawler, and we'll find out today who their third man is going to be. Mad Dog Vachon, come on in. The talk of this town and the talk of professional wrestling, for that matter, the match that has now been made by promoter Gagne, Vern Gagne, a death match between yourself and Jerry Blackwell. Let's start from the beginning. We know the reasons why you wanted this kind of a match. We also know the ground rules, but could you explain?
Well, it's very simple. The match is going to end when one of us is going to get carried out of the ring on the stretcher. That's all there is to it.
Well,
it's very simple. Don't try to complicate things. When one of us is going to get carried out on the stretcher, cannot continue. It's going to be the end of one of us. And I guarantee you, my friend, it's going to be the end of Jerry Blackwell.
I think it is my journalistic duty, Mad Dog, if I can just elaborate on that a little bit. Falls do not count. And obviously, when one man cannot continue, the referee is going to call for a 30-second rest count. At that time, he will begin a 10 count. And at the end of the 10 count, if your opponent or yourself, for that matter, cannot answer the bell, the man who can walk out or even crawl out will be the winner indeed.
And you imagine that? I had to beg Vern Gagne, the new promoter of Chicago. I had to go almost on my knees to beg him to give me a match like that. He says he was against his principle. It's got nothing to do with wrestling. I agree with him 100% with Vern Gagne. It has nothing to do with wrestling in that match. But I reminded him what he did to Greg, his son, when he broke his ribs. I reminded him also what he did to Brad Regan when he went flat, when broke his ankle. He still got the pins in it. I reminded Vern Gagne what he, Blackwell, did to me. Put me out of wrestling for 2.5 years. That's against principles, too. That's against the rules and regulation, but it doesn't matter. As long as Blackwell does the injuries, Blackwell does the punishment. Well, this is going to be all over. This is a death match, my friend. And one of us is going to have to leave. Maybe feet first.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, they're calling it the death match. Mad Dog Vachon, Jerry Blackwell here on Saturday night, the 18th. We're going to get you right back. Rick Martel in action. I'm going to be talking to him in a moment, but Wahoo McDaniel, I just had to bring you in. I'm certain the fans of the Windy City recall the original challenge of Nick Bockwinkel. He said he wouldn't put the World Tag Team title on the line, but instead he would give you the members of the family, namely Lanza Ventura and Nick Bockwinkel himself, you to get a couple of other partners, and they would make it a six-man tag team bout. You astounded me somewhat, but not for long, when you announced that Jerry Lawler, King Jerry Lawler, would be at your side. We know the reasons for the bout, but now the big question is, who will the third man be, Wahoo McDaniel?
Well, you know, Bockwinkel doesn't have to pick Lanza and Ventura, because they're on my list anyway for what they did to me. Now, Shan, when somebody said something bad about wrestling, or somebody did something, who took Bockwinkel to the limit, he dropped a man right out of his head in front of millions of people. Well, that's my kind of man.
And he, of course, has got no love lost for Mr. Bockwinkel, especially.
Nobody has any love for them, and especially me. You know, here they go and pick on a poor little Indian. Three guys. Now they're going around bragging and telling me they knocked me out with one punch, then Heenan. Well, let me tell you something, Heenan. I've got myself, I've got Lawler, and I'm going to have Dick the Bruiser in my corner.
You have got to be kidding me. That does, in fact, Wahoo McDaniel, come as somewhat of a shock. Of course, Dick the Bruiser, a legend here in the Windy City, along with Jerry Lawler and yourself. What a threesome, to say the least.
That's right. You know, he's just like us. He'll do anything to win and to get even, and that's what we're there for, to get even.
I thank you. Wahoo McDaniel, the great Indian star, two-time All-American out of Oklahoma, 9 times in the National Football League, 9 great seasons, now one of the great ones in professional wrestling, Dick the Bruiser. Jerry Lawler and Wahoo McDean Chump and Jimmy Bronsell in action. Hello again to the Windy City. Gene Okerlund here. All-Star Wrestling is on the air. The University of Illinois, Chicago, in the pavilion at Harrison and Racine, the 8th, Saturday night, June the 18th, 8:30 p.m., and Chicago promoter Vern Gagne has truly put together a barn burner, including the collision of Mad Dog Vachon and Jerry Blackwell in a death match. More on that later in this television program. Six-man tag team action. It is going to be Wahoo McDaniel, King Jerry Lawler, and Chicago's own Dick the Bruiser to meet the trio of Nick Bockwinkel, Blackjack Lanza, and Jesse the Body Ventura. Gentlemen, come on in. Greg Gagne, Jimmy Brunzell, tag team champions of the world, but single matches. First of all, Greg, you have Bobby the Brain Heenan.
That's right, Gene. You know, this is one that Heenan asked for. He was out here the last few weeks shooting his mouth off on what he wanted to do to me and to keep my nose out of his business. Well, Heenan, I don't care what your business is. I've never had my nose in it. But you've got yours in mind, because when you step in the ring with me, we're going to find out once and for all what kind of a wrestler you really are. And deep down, I know what that is. And that's why they call you the Weasel. Everything you do is from sneaking up from behind. That's when he's at his best, Gene. And he has no one to help him. There will be no Blackjack Lanza, no Nick Bockwinkel in his corner. Heenan, it's you and me. And brother, we're going to straighten this thing out once and for all.
All right, a new and a very wealthy, I might add, Ken Patera. The big man, he is strong. I'm very curious, Jim. Here's a man at 270 pounds. You know about his tremendous physical strength. What kind of strategy right now are you making in preparation for this particular bout?
Well, Gene, a lot of people have asked me how you deal with big men. And Ken Patera, having the reputation that he does, right now he's got added incentive. He's been given $250,000 to help Adnan Casey get the world's tag team championship belts from Greg and myself, and I know I'm going to have a lot of pressure on me. The secret for me to be successful against Ken Patera is to control his body. And how do I control his body? I control his head. Ken Patera, I'm going to say this right now. If I can get a hold of your head and tire you out and keep that 270 pounds and all that muscle down on the mat, we'll see how spry and how strong you are after 15 or 20 minutes.
You know, Jimmy, I am certain that Patera's also got the possibility of injury in the back of his mind. Greg,
Gene, it shouldn't be too hard to control Patera's head, because there's not a whole lot up there. So I'm going to be watching this one with great expectations, because Jim has to win this one. There is a lot of pressure on him in this match.
All right, I did mention injury, and you know that is always possible when you're in the ring, and especially with a man as tough as Patera.
Well, you do have to keep that in the back of your mind, but you got to be positive, and I'm going to be positive against Patera.
Gentlemen, I thank you very much. Greg Gagne, Jim Brunzell, both big single matches for them on the tremendous card. Coming to more exciting action coming up. By the way, I want to remind the great fans of Milwaukee, a tremendous all-star wrestling card coming up in Milwaukee on Saturday night, June the 25th, 8 o'clock, in the Milwaukee Auditorium. The promoter up there, Dennis Hilgard, talking to top stars from throughout the professional wrestling world for that June 25th date. This weekend, here in town, the University of Illinois, Chicago Circle in the pavilion, 5 minutes from the loop, plenty of good parking, not a bad seat, by the way, in that tremendous facility, and what a card. One of the matches that myself and many, many others associated with professional wrestling are going to be watching very, very closely is the death match between Jerry Blackwell and Mad Dog Vachon. I had a difficult time in running down the Mad Dog, and you won't believe where I found him recently. Just a minute, Mad Dog Vachon. I have been looking high and low for you, and
what
finally...
What are you doing here? What told you I was here?
I had to run you down, Mad Dog. Obviously, some things that we've had to talk about, you've been totally unavailable. Mad Dog,
May I ask, what in the world are you doing back here?
This is for my friend, Jerry Fatwell.
What is this, Mad Dog?
This is gonna be special delivery. It's a pine box.
Well, is
it? You know what they use a pine box for?
I've got a good idea.
Who told you I was there in the first place?
Well, I can't get into that. Mad Dog Vachon.
You know what? I've waited a long time for something like this. You know, there's something that bothers you that you could no longer live with it. But I've think about this for a long time. When Jerry Blackwell put me out of wrestling for 2.5 years and I had to work in the mines to make my body strong, I thought about this when I was pounding with a pick. I said to myself, deep down in the mines, deep down when it was dark and cool, I said, wouldn't that be a nice place for someone like Blackwell? Wow. That's why I had the idea of building this pine box. Taboot.
What does
taboot? That's the word
in
Arabic for this. You know, sometime, my friends, there's something that's gonna give. This world is not big enough for both of us. This is a death match coming up, and one of us will have to leave this world.
There is more action continuing here in a moment or two on All-Star Wrestling this morning. The big one coming up at the University of Illinois, Chicago in the Pavilion. This coming Saturday night, 8:30. By the way, tickets available in advance at the Pavilion box office and at all Ticketron locations in the greater Chicagoland area. Jerry Blackwell, come on in. Sheik, Ken Patera, gentlemen, if you would. Earlier, I am certain you saw a man at work in Mad Dog Vachon.
First of all, would you say this is a little bit of a conspiracy? A ploy to keep this man and myself from becoming the world tag team champions on the part of Mr. Vern Gagne? You know, Vern Gagne and Mad Dog Vachon wrestled this man and myself. And in order for us to get in the ring, we were promised a world tag team match. So why are we not getting that instead of me going in a match, a death match with Mad Dog Vachon? Vern Gagne come off on his arm and broke it. He thought he had saved his son from losing a world title, but it didn't work. This man was too smart for all of you. He had too much money, too much power. And he come up with one of the greatest wrestlers in the world today. And we're going to become the world tag team champions. But let me get to Mad Dog Vachon. Do you think that's the work of a sane man, what he was doing? Do you think it's the work of a sane man building a pine box for me? I know, what do you want to do? You want to put me in the ground. But it might backfire, Mad Dog Vachon. You've backed me in a corner and there's nowhere to go. I've been forced into this match. And I've got to come out. A death match. Do you know what it is? It means to fight to the finish. To one man has to have somebody to come out with a stretcher and help him away from the ring. And the other man needs help too. Well, Mad Dog Vachon, it might be like way back in the Old West, where they'd carry the bad guys out and then make them dig their own grave. Maybe you've dug your own grave by building that box, and I'm going to put you in it. I don't care what I have to do or how I have to do it. There's no rules, no regulations. I come off the top of the building. Anything I want to do,
settle down.
How can you settle down?
I'll cut this interview off.
Let me tell you something. Sheik Blackwell is going to be in there with a crazy man. You don't have any friends, do you, Mad Dog? Well, Sheik Blackwell has a lot of friends, Adnan and Ken Patera. We're going to be in the building. We're going to be in the corner. And where are you going to be? You're going to be 6 feet under, boy. Once and for all, we're going to finish you. And Jimmy Brunzell, remember a few years ago when you were injured and you and Greggy Boy had to relinquish the World Tag Team belts because you couldn't compete anymore? Well, that's exactly what's going to happen to you.
All right, Sheik.
Don't you want to hang us? I have a plan. And have some idea for the Mad Dog. The taboot is built for him. He shall be resting in the
Jabba,
double.
I am sorry.
Hello.
I am sorry.
Remember anything I have to do, Mad Dog Vachon, I don't care. I'm going to do it, and I'm going to walk out of that
ring. Back up into the ring for more exciting action. One of the old lines from a television program from some years back, something that went to the effect of the events that alter and illuminate our times. I can't believe what I'm hearing from Jerry Blackwell. I'm certain the fans here in Chicago recall vividly that Blackwell initially asked for Mad Dog Vachon in this kind of a match. Now, I can't help but get the impression that Blackwell perhaps a little reluctant to get involved. He may be trying to back out, I don't know. I am certain, though, that particular match is signed for this Saturday night, and it will take place. Gentlemen, come on in. An ever-changing world of professional wrestling. Now, all of a sudden, six-man tag team action. I don't mind telling you, some surprises. Wahoo McDaniel, Jerry Lawler, and Dick the Bruiser.
Jerry Lawler is a man who punched me within an inch of my life. Now, hear what I said, punched. Then he takes and teams up with Wahoo McDaniels, who we know stuck his nose into other people's business and runs around chopping people across the throat, also illegal. And what do they get as a third partner? They get none other than Dick the Bruiser, a man who happens to be one of Chicago's favorite sons, and I don't know why, except that they have allowed him the latitude of what no other wrestler has ever been able to get away with. The three of them, we are going into the ring against. There's only one intention, as far as I'm concerned, that Mr. McDaniels or that Lawler want. They want to somehow or another do me in so that somehow or another I will not be able to defend the heavyweight championship of the world. That's what it comes down to with these three individuals.
Well, you've got to be kidding yourself, Nick Blackwell.
I'm not kidding myself. Yeah. You know what I'm speaking is the truth.
I know it is. I know it is. Blackjack Lanza.
Wahoo McDaniel, King Jerry Lawler, and the person least likely that we respect in the whole world, Dick the Bruiser, means absolutely nothing to the Heenan family. We've handled him many, many times before.
You know, I'm sick and tired of this whole thing. It's not bad enough that Wahoo McDaniels can run berserk, do whatever he wants. Jerry Lawler has no regard for the rules. You know, Bruiser's track record. Wahoo McDaniels has got people chanting. Wahoo McDaniels, they're chanting, they're making Indian calls, they're doing everything. And this man is a borderline case, and he's going to get out there and chop and do whatever he wants. He's badly mistaken. Now, I just casually mentioned for Greg Gagne to keep his nose out of my business. I didn't mean I was going to sign for a match with him. Now, I've got a match with Greg Gagne. I've got to be in their corner. Don't you see this? I'm tired of being pushed around and dictated to.
All right, Jesse Ventura, a lot of talk around town about you lately.
Yeah, let me tell you something. Let's go down the list. You got Jerry Lawler, Mr. Punch-Out. You got Wahoo McDaniel, Mr. Chopper, and Dick the Loser, Barroom Brawler. Now, what kind of wrestling ability do these three dudes got at one time? Not too much. And I'll lay something else on you, Mean Gene. In the brains department, we know that there's definitely plenty lacking. I got a challenge for you, Lawler. Hit me once in the jaw, the steel jaw. I ain't never been knocked out on my feet with one punch, and you ain't the man to do it. And I'm going to whip you out of your crown, boy.
Right, thank you very much,
you
gentlemen.
You think the Chicago Bulls...
Seen Brad Ringens in action. Wahoo McDaniel, I want you to stand by as I tell the great wrestling fans of Chicago about the big one coming up this coming Saturday night, University of Illinois, Chicago, in the pavilion. It's 5 minutes from the loop, plenty of convenient parking, and tickets are available in advance at Ticketron and at the box office at the pavilion. On that card, as you know, the death match between Mad Dog Vachon and Jerry Blackwell. In addition, you're going to be seeing Greg Gagne meeting Bobby Heenan. Heenan wants no part of this match, by the way. Ken Patera and a new wealthy Ken Patera to meet Jumpin' Jimmy Brunzell. Rick Martel going against a man by the name of Colt. We don't know a great deal about him. The return of the Yugoslavian. Chris Markoff, he'll be back in town to go against Brad Ringens. Wahoo McDaniel, six-man tag team action. Yourself, Jerry Lawler, and Dick the Bruiser to meet the trio of Bockwinkel, Lanza, and Jesse Ventura. And I want to refresh your memory, as well as the fans of Chicago, as we take a look at this right here.
Lanza working on him. Here comes Heenan. Oh, he's digging in his pocket. A foreign object he's got. There's the brass knuckles, and he goes right after. Goes right after Wahoo McDaniel. Over in this corner, Heenan putting it right back in his pocket. The referee didn't see it. Oh, I'll tell you now. After Wahoo is bleeding. They really nailed him. Here comes Rocky Stone. Here comes Jimmy Doe. Jesse the Body throws Stone out. Lanza throws Jimmy Doe out. Wow, McDaniel bleeding profusely. Here comes the Baron. The Baron, the Clawmaster, goes after Lanza, after Ventura. Throw off, I'll tell you. And now, wow, McDaniel's ready to go after Bobby the Weasel Heenan. Heenan bails out, gets back in. McDaniel catches him. Tears it. Apparently, Heenan's clothes right off his body. The Baron brings Ventura, chases him out of the ring area. Wahoo McDaniel has Heenan.
Wahoo McDaniel, you split Bobby Heenan wide open. I still can't believe it.
Let me tell you something. When I see that, it makes me my Indian blood boil all over. And, you know, I just wish I could have hurt him worse. And that's something horrible for me to say. But the man stuck his nose in my business. Now they want to come back and get me. Bockwinkel, Lanza, and Ventura. Well, Ventura and Lanza should have had enough. But now Bockwinkel wants to hide behind him. Why didn't he come by himself and get me? Well, I went and got Jerry Lawler, who has taken his toll on Bockwinkel.
Oh,
and I got Chicago's own Dick the Bruiser, which I've known for a long time. Let's just see how tough they are and when they, how much they're going to get out back on me.
I thank you very much, Wahoo McDaniel. Fans, don't forget this Saturday night at the Pavilion, big, big card, including six-man tag team action that this band is going to be a part of. All right, fans, you've just seen Blackjack Lanza in action. And good morning again, Chicago. Gene Okerlund, All-Star Wrestling is on the air. I should point out all of the interviews you are seeing at this time pre-recorded before the big card last night out at the University of Illinois Chicago in the Pavilion. Big card coming up on Saturday, July the 23rd. We're going to have more details on that big one as promoters go ahead and work with the top names in professional wrestling today, one of which has got to be World's Heavyweight Champion Nick Bockwinkel, signed, by the way, on that next big card to defend the World's Heavyweight title. Gentlemen, as I ruminate on the state of professional wrestling today, I've got to point out to both of you, plus Jesse Ventura, that it's quite conceivable, Mr. Bockwinkel, one of you, as the fans watch us now, could be laid up, could be out of action.
It is conceivable, isn't it? It is likely conceivable as well that either the Bruiser, Mr. Lawler, or the Crazy Indian could be laid up and out of action. You could have started the interview off in that same tone, couldn't you? But no, you decided you want to take and do your little favor for all the cretinous humanoids sitting out there and give it your little sly cutie into us. But you must understand something, Mr. Okerlund, that when we step into the ring, do you think we have any intention of getting ourselves laid up, busted up, let alone losing? It is very conceivable that you might be looking at the winners of the match last night, and that we may have racked up all three, the Bruiser, the Crusher, and the Crazy Indian.
All right. For a healthy body, I think it's more important for you than any other in professional wrestling today.
That's true.
Due to the fact that you currently hold the World's Heavyweight Championship, Nick Bockwinkel.
You noticed. Gosh, isn't it nice? His eyes are working today, too. This thing here, ladies and gentlemen, the World's Heavyweight Wrestling Championship belt is emblematic of the finest within our sport, our profession today. Of all the athletes in the world, whether it's football, baseball, or whatever it is, none is so important as when you come down to the single competitor, when he and he alone go against another man in physical combat. And that is what this is. It is the zenith. I hold it. I have held it now for nearly 8 years outside of a couple of short spells. Oh, you wanted to bring that out just in case I missed it? You're really, really hustling today, aren't you? It is very simple. When he says that I must stay in physical shape, you are correct. And I, believe me, I did everything in my power. I'm sure we'll have done everything in our power.
One thing, Nick, he does not know or realize, the people, any member of the Heenan family is in tip-top shape constantly. It's the only way that Mr. Heenan picks his people. They are intelligent, they are strong, and they are excellent wrestlers. Unlike Wahoo McDaniel and the runt Dick the Bruiser. I'd like to get this hold on Dick the Bruiser. You know, the only trouble is I might hurt my back bending down to his height to slap this
gentleman,
Texas
brainbuster
on his
own
head.
Gentlemen, we are out of time. We're going to get you right back. The brilliant Canadian star, Ricky Martel, out of Quebec City, Quebec, in action here on All-Star Wrestling. Couple of dates for the fans in this neck of the woods that I want to point out. First of all, out in the northwestern part of the state, not that far away, actually, Rockford, Illinois, Friday night, June the 24th, 8:15 p.m., Boylan High. Tremendous all-star wrestling card for the fans in and around Rockford. Now, in addition, Milwaukee, Saturday night, June the 25th, 8 o'clock, Milwaukee Auditorium. Tremendous all-star wrestling card negotiated by the promoter in Milwaukee, Dennis Hilgart. It's going to be a big night at the Milwaukee Auditorium this coming Saturday night for All-Star Wrestling. I consider myself a responsible broadcast journalist. I've had the opportunity for many, many years to cover this great sport. Baron Von Raschke, come on in. This great sport of professional wrestling. And I was somewhat disappointed in the journalistic efforts in the June 2nd edition of the Chicago Tribune, journalist Steve Chapman. I don't know if you had an opportunity, Baron, to read that particular article or not, but it was not.
Yeah, I have read this. You know this man, this Stephen Chapman, he comes up and tries to say that art mirrors life. And he tries to draw an illusion that wrestling mirrors life. Well, with his pseudo intellectual verbiage, he is trying to put down American wrestling fans and American wrestlers. Well, I have news for you. You may have passed your college test in math psychology, or you may not have. After reading this, I may doubt it very much.
Well,
but I tell you something. The American wrestling fan is very important, a very worthwhile entity in itself. And Herr Chapman, when you put down the American wrestling fan, you put down Baron Von Raschke, because these are my people. And there is absolutely nothing wrong with them. And I tell you this, America is a great country. Wrestling is a great sport. Wrestling fans are the best in the world. And anytime, any place, I am willing to step in the ring and prove it against anyone. Anyone!
I will defend Baron Von Raschke, freedom of press. However, I've got to ask you right now, Vern Gagne, promoter here in Chicago, any exchange of dialogue regarding the next big upcoming card and any part that you may be of that.
I have been in contact, and I have told him I will face anyone in the ring in Chicago at any time.
Thank you.
And that is all the people.
Baron Von Raschke. Seen strongman Kent Patera. I am going to give him a moment or two to don that very colorful attire. Sheik Adnan L. Casey, I do want you to come on out here as I remind the great fans of the Windy City, the next big date at the University of Illinois, Chicago, Chicago Circle, in the Pavilion, Harrison and Racine, Saturday night, July the 23rd, 8:30 p.m. start on that one. And by the way, tickets available in advance, of course, at Ticketron and at the Pavilion box office. Nick Bockwinkle signed to defend the world's heavyweight title. No opponent has been named by promoter here in Chicago, Vern Gagne, for Bockwinkle. One match signed, the impressive Mr. Saito from Tokyo, Japan, will be going against rock and roll Buck Zumhoff. Sheik Adnan L. Casey, you're the man responsible for putting together the team of Jerry Blackwell and Ken Patera. You have stated quite openly you feel this is the team that ultimately will be the World Tag Team Champion.
Without a doubt, Mr. Gene Oakland, this is the best team, and we shall complete the mission.
The mission being?
To capture the tag team champion of the world and head it back to Baghdad, Iraq. Because my people are awaiting. 800 million Arab in the world are awaiting your return, my brother.
Just a minute. Where is Jerry Blackwell?
Don't you worry about his highness.
His Highness is having a rest. He's taking it easy because the harem is taking care of him.
All right.
And he will be ready with my new brother. And the mission is the tag team champion of the world.
An already wealthy Ken Patera. Your thoughts, sir?
That's right. A lot of people still say Ken Patera sold out to the Arabs. Of course I did. For $250,000. Wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? You'd be a fool not to.
Well, there's something called respect. There's something called pride in your country,
well,
too,
I'm
going
to tell you something. I went to the Olympic Games on my own. I went to the Pan American Games on my own. I won all the gold medals in amateurism. But what did the American people do for Ken Patera? Nothing. I didn't receive anything until the Arabs came along and offered me rooms full of gold, rooms full of jewels, limousines, jet airplanes, and my own harem, and anything else that I want. When we accomplish the mission, and like Adnan El Casey says, that mission is to destroy and win the tag team championships of the world from Greg Gagne and Jim Brunzel. But it's quite obvious that there's something afoul because they keep throwing goon squads in front of us. When is the time going to come that you two yellow-bellied sapsuckers get off your bellies and defend those titles against the number one tag team? And that number one tag team is Ken Patera and Jerry Blackwell.
Well, gentlemen, you're going to have to prove that according to what I hear from the championship committee. I thank you, Ken Patera, Zeke Adnan El Casey, Sanzine, world certainly to date, to the great fans of professional wrestling down by not capturing the world's heavyweight crown from Nick Bockwinkel in front of that record-breaking crowd of 28,000 in St. Paul, Minnesota, back in the month of May. The largest crowd to attend a professional wrestling match indoors. 18,000 plus in the Civic Center and another 10,000 strong watching on closed circuit TV. Fans, so very, very important. We show you that action. Hulk Hogan meeting Nick Bockwinkel. All right, fans, truly we've got some great action coming up. Best of luck to Tony La Russa. And the Chicago White Sox, and of course Dallas Green, and the Cubs. Great baseball town, the city of Chicago, and truly a tremendous resurgence in fan enthusiasm for professional wrestling. I huddled just moments ago with Vern Gagne, quick to inform me at the request of Dick the Bruiser. He has signed another match. Dick the Bruiser to be going against a member of the Bobby Heenan family in the big Texan, Black Jack Lanza, and that Texas brainbuster of his. You heard, of course, that Nick Bockwinkel's title defense will be against none other than the great Indian star out of Oklahoma, Wahoo McDaniel. A lot of eyes are going to be on Chicago on that Saturday, July the 23rd, date for that tremendous card at the University of Illinois, Chicago, in the pavilion at Harrison and Racine, 8:30 p.m. start as usual. Get your tickets in advance. Baron Von Raschke. Baron, come on in, if you would, please. Baron, the Clawmaster. So many things happening throughout the AWA, and I know that you've expressed an interest to promoters to get the biggest and the best competition possible for you.
That is richtig. You know, Mad Dog Vachon is recuperating from a very, very tough match with Herr Jerry Blackwell, the Sheik, the Ayatollah, whatever he wants to call himself. But this nest of thieves, run by Sheik Casey, Patera, Blackwell, and Casey himself. Anytime, anywhere, any place, either Mad Dog or myself will step into the ring with you one at a time or all together. It doesn't matter to us. You know something? You are talking about the fans from Chicago for the baseballs, the White Sox, the Cubs and the footballs, the Bears and the Blitz, and all the great sports in Chicago.
The Blackhawks, and of course, the Chicago Bulls of NBA fame. This is a great sports town, Baron.
That is exactly right. The fans stay behind their teams 100%. And they stay behind the Mad Dog and the Baron. And that's what's going to help Mad Dog. That's what's going to help the Baron. We're challenging any and all comers. You know something, Herr Gene.
Yes.
Wahoo McDaniel has finally gotten a chance to wrestle Nick Bockwinkel for the world championship.
Pick a winner for me in that one.
But I am very happy for Wahoo McDaniel. I'm not going to pick the winner, but I am going to do this. I haven't had a title shot for a very long time. And regardless from whom the winner is, Baron Von Raschke wants his name on the dotted line, whoever the champion is, after Wahoo fights Bockwinkel for the belt. And that is all the people need.
One question before you go. Is it Wahoo or Wahoo?
Wahoo!
Thank you very much. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, one of the brutalest title bouts I have ever had an opportunity of eyewitnessing took place during the month of May. The incredible Hulk Hogan, this much talked about young man, in front of the largest indoor crowd in North America to eyewitness anywhere in the world for that matter, 28,000 plus, seeing Hulk Hogan challenge Nick Bockwinkel for the world's title crown. Quite a bout indeed. And of course, there is action in the ring right now as we join that particular match. Watch it very, very closely. All right, ladies and gentlemen, prior to the introductions for tonight's world title bout, first of all, I would like to introduce the promoter in the Twin Cities, the veteran septuagenarian entrepreneur, Wally Carbo. Wally Carbo. And ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinguished pleasure and privilege to introduce the president of the American Wrestling Association, the Honorable Stanley W. Blackburn. President of the AWA, commissioned to referee this world heavyweight title bout, the great Englishman, none other than Lord James Blears. Referee Lord Blears. I thank you, gentlemen. Now the introduction of the man defending the world's heavyweight title. One fall, 1 hour. From Beverly Hills, California. He weighs 245 pounds. Heavyweight championship, one fall, 1 hour. Take it away, Rod Trongard.
Thank you very much, Gene. Hello again, everyone. Lord James Blears, along with Stanley W. Blackburn, president of the AWA, both in the ring now, listening. Stanley Blackburn is listening as Lord James Blears explains the rules to the incredible Hulk Hogan, who is the challenger, and many say that in 1 hour or less time from now, he will be the champion. Hogan wants the crowd to go to work for him. If Hogan gets it, he's gonna know he's been in a dogfight for sure. Field throw, a flying mare. They try for a leg drop, and Bockwinkel rolls out of the way. Both men are stunned and injured. The drama races here at the St. Paul Civic Center with 20,000 fans screaming in the background and more, thousands more at the... A double arm smash to the back of Hulk Hogan from the champion. Longer this can possibly go. A cover here by Hulk Hogan. It may be over now. One, two, no. Somehow or another, Bockwinkel twisted out just when it looked like he was going to body slam Hulk Hogan. Hulk had too much weight for him, and he had Bockwinkel off balance and had him on his back on the canvas, but could not pin him. The boot into the midsection again. Foot to the midsection. Bockwinkel may be hurt badly. Oh, the crowd loves this man. They so want to see him wear that championship belt out of the ring, but only time will answer that. Again, the Irish whip across the ring, and an elbow smash into the forehead. Here comes the Hulk. Here comes the elbow smash to the champion. Hulk turns around, covers him for one, for two, but that is all. Lord Blears does not count three. Hogan thought he had him. What does Hogan have in mind now? Try it across the ring again. He goes with him into the corner. Oh, Bockwinkel moves out. And Hogan drives that shoulder into the top turnbuckle and may have injured himself. Now the sleeper by Bockwinkel, the Nick Bockwinkel sleeper hold on the incredible Hulk Hogan. But maybe Bockwinkel is not strong enough to maintain it. He has it on. He's gone piggyback on the incredible Hulk. But the Hulkster has not gone to sleep yet. Bockwinkel losing strength with every passing second. Blear says no. The Hulk bending over may try to monkey flip him over some way or another. There he goes. And Blears is down. The referee, Lord Blears, is stunned and down and flat on his back as he took more of that blow than Nick Bockwinkel or Hulk Hogan did. Blears, groggy, shaky, trying to get up. Again, Bockwinkel puts the sleeper hold on. Blears trying to come to. He's in the corner. The sleeper. Blears goes down. Bockwinkel holding on. The Hulk may be losing it. Now he drives both Blears and Bockwinkel into the corner. And Blears is out. He is absolutely out. Isn't in much better shape, nor is Hogan. But Blears is the one who is the worst for wear in the ring now. Again, the sleeper hold by Hulk Hogan from Nick Bockwinkel. And Bockwinkel flips him out of the ring. Rather, Hogan flips Bockwinkel out of the ring. I beg your pardon. We're at the 20-minute mark. Hogan over talking with Lord Blears. Bockwinkel will come back in with a boot leg. Down he goes. Here comes Hogan. Here is the leg smash. Here is the cover. Here is the count. One, two, three. It's all over. Hulk Hogan has done it. Hulk Hogan is the champion. Hogan has defeated Nick Bockwinkel. He has the belt. He is the king!
ladies and gentlemen, I have just been informed by the referee that President Blackburn is of the opinion that Hulk Hogan threw Nick Bockwinkel over the top rope. Because of that, the Hulk is disqualified and the belt remains with Nick Bockwinkel. Champion, but he refuses to give up the belt, and he now throws Bobby Heenan across the ring. He throws Nick Bockwinkel over the rope and out of the ring, and that, ladies and gentlemen, Hulk Hogan grabs away the championship belt from Lord Blair's, the referee, who on consultation with Stanley Blackburn, and it was Blackburn, the president of the AWA, who made the determination that Hogan had flipped Bockwinkel over the top rope and thus is disqualified, and he does not get the championship.
Some kind of a match indeed. Bobby Heenan, Nick Bockwinkel, as I privately told Hulk Hogan, perhaps the darkest time is just before dawn. What a big match, very controversial in the opinion of many.
My entire career, one of the most frequent questions asked is, what was your toughest match? And until recently, there were several. But I can stand here unequivocally and tell the entire sports world that the match you just witnessed was my toughest. I felt like I was knocked out.
Matt, no one knows where he is. They can't find him. Right now, his mother's probably on her hands and knees trying to coax him out from under the bed. Floor's all wet from tears. He doesn't answer the phone. No mail to his home. No one can find him. He's hiding. Well, I don't blame you for hiding, Hogan. You were embarrassed. You came out there and gave 200%. You hit this man with everything you had, and you still did not leave the ring the champion of the world. And you never will, Hogan. You did the best thing you could have done was take off and hide. And I'm glad, and I'm going to speak for the family. I am personally glad we've seen the last of the incredible Hulk Hogan.
Well,
let me tell all the wrestling fans one last word. Hogan, I do now know something. Having gone through hell and the toughest match of my career with you, considered the most promising man in the world in this sport, I now know how to beat you. And if I ever get my hands on you again, if you think you were humiliated before because of what you failed to accomplish, you will be humiliated even more, because I will take and accomplish the one thing that nobody else has done. I will defeat you, pin you, and beat you.
You better stay hiding, Hogan.
I thank you very much, gentlemen. Bobby Heenan, Nick Bockwinkel, comments regarding the incredible Hulk Hogan and that fantastic match, the toughest of Nick Bockwinkel's career, according to him, that we have just seen. Have a good week. So long. Jerry Blackwell in action. Good morning again, Chicago. Happy 4th of July weekend. All-Star Wrestling is on the air. Big news this past week, ladies and gentlemen. Rock and Roll Buck Zumhoff toppling Mike Graham, longtime light heavyweight champion of the world. And Rock and Roll Zumhoff, your brand new light heavyweight champion, in the locker room at the St. Paul Civic Center, St. Paul, Minnesota, where just moments ago, somewhere in the neighborhood of 14,000 people saw Jerry Blackwell and Ken Patera arrest the titles from the High Flyers, Greg Gagne and Jim Brunzell. But I might add, Sheik, added on LKC,
yes,
tremendously controversial match. I'm going to ask you point blank, did or did not? And I want just yes or no. Did you hit Jim Brunzell in the head with this cast?
And worth it.
Wait a minute. I should point out, Sheik, that match, by the way, earlier tonight will be on videotape, and of course it will be available to the members of the AWA Championship Committee. Jerry Blackwell.
You show it to anybody you want. But let me tell you where these world titles and these three men are going. We're going home to Baghdad, Iraq, to enjoy the wealth and the riches that we've worked for and the ones that we've worked for getting the world tag team titles.
The mission that we promised Edna and Al Casey, and those are the world championship titles, and they're going back to Baghdad because we were promised the riches and the wealth that the Arab world can deliver. And we deliver.
Hold on.
And they shall deliver.
Wait a minute. Wally Carville.
All right. I know there's no return clause in this match, but you are the world's champions, and you will have to defend your belts. A little while ago, I talked to Stanley Bradford, the president of the AWA.
I'll be the champion.
What are you talking about, Wally?
There is no return clause. We're on our way to Baghdad.
Well,
what are they talking about? How can we go home? How can we get the wealth we was promised? We was promised all the riches in the world when we're
off and running with All Star Wrestling. Television matchmaker Wally Carbo. Wally, come on in if you would. The talk of professional sports this past week, the fact that we have New World Tag Team Champions in Jerry Blackwell and Ken Patera. Sheik Adnan El Casey has made it known that he intends to go back to Baghdad, Iraq, and stay there and celebrate for who knows how long. What is the status of Blackwell and Patera right now?
I don't care what the Sheik does, takes Blackwell Patera to Baghdad and celebrate, but before the title match, Patera and Blackwell have signed contracts and commitments all through August. Now, the minute that they miss any of these commitments and any of the title defenses, they will be stripped of the title by the A.
Jacine Brad Ringens in action. Hello again, Chicago. Gene Okerlund and All-Star Wrestling is off and running. Brad Ringens, of course, the young man that just about carved up the world's heavyweight champion, Nick Bockwinkel, in front of national television audience. In light of what has happened recently to Bockwinkel at the hands of the incredible Hulk Hogan, I don't mind telling you, it is going to be a severe test to the world champion when a very qualified contender in Wahoo McDaniel challenges Bockwinkel this coming Saturday night at the University of Illinois Chicago in the Pavilion, Harrison and Racine, at 8:30 p.m. Tickets available in advance at the box office and at all Ticketron locations. Plenty of good seats are still available. Gentlemen, if you would, Bobby Heenan, Blackjack Lanza, one-on-one against Chicago's favorite son, Dick the Bruiser.
You said it, I didn't. Chicago's favorite son means absolutely nothing to the Heenan family. We've had our dealings before with Dickie Bruiser, and he's always gone down to his knees begging for mercy. It's going to be the same thing in Chicago.
Time will tell on that.
Yeah,
Bobby,
will tell us something. Wahoo McDaniels, first of all, should not even have a championship match. He shouldn't even be wrestling for the championship of the world. And now the word comes out that Hulk Hogan has purchased a ringside ticket.
Bobby Heenan, how are you going to be able to concentrate on the efforts of Nick Bockwinkel with Hulk Hogan having a ringside
ticket? How can you concentrate? You're in a match with Wahoo McDaniels. First of all, this man will do anything he can to win a match. He throws illegal shots. Right, I want that taken off. I want that taken off. Hogan cannot be at ringside. I want the promoter, I want the AWA to make sure that man is not allowed in the building. I've got to sit at ringside and concern myself with the well-being of the champion of the world. Worrying about Wahoo McDaniels. I don't want to worry about Hulk Hogan sitting behind my back, sitting over there, sitting over here. This is for the championship of the world. They're trying to soften us up. They throw in Brad Ringens. They give McDaniels the championship match. And now they say Hogan can buy a ticket. He can do whatever he wants. You know what they're doing. They want that championship away from us so bad. They're going through any lengths to get it.
I'll tell you, Bobby Heenan, a very heated Bobby Heenan. Come on in. Baron von Raschke recently added to the card to meet Dave the Redneck Schultz out of Nashville, Tennessee.
Well, this here Redneck Schultz, he's coming to the AWA with high aspirations. I have heard from his reputation. He has been a champion in many parts of the world. He's coming here. Coming here for one purpose, and that is to challenge the wrestlers of the AWA to go after the world title. Well, Herr Redneck Schultz, your first test is going to be very severe. you are meeting the Clawmaster, Baron Von Reschke. And I tell you something, I'm coming prepared to fight, and that is all you need to know.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the big Bavarian, the Clawmaster, Baron Von Reschke. Stay tuned, Chicago. More exciting action coming up. Progress at this time.
Oh, got him right on the ear. And that hurts. That's a big out. A flying body, body block. One, two, and Bockwinkel. Unbowed and unbeaten so far in this match, right? There are photographers all around this ring from all the major magazines, sporting magazines all over the country. Japan, Mexico, some of the local and area television station crews, camera crews are here. This auditorium is packed. Wrestling enjoying a tremendous interest, renaissance, if you wish to call it that. There's never been any winning interest, but boy, they just keep packing more people in the auditoriums all over the world. Not just here. Heenan protesting to the timekeeper and ring steward and ring announcer, Al DeRusche, I think. That's to no avail. It's just a study in frustration when they do that. But I have announced, been ring announcer and sit ringside, and they'll either the people or the wrestlers will take, you know, and give you some guff, and there's nothing you can do about it. You're just doing your job. Got a 1-2. Martel had to get out of that one. Look at that! In the rope! There's an knee and a kidneys for Bockwinkel, and there's an elbow smash a little bit higher. Apparently Martel is going to try to take and soften him up with those elbow smashes. He better not take too much time in between. Why is he waiting? Why is he waiting? I don't know. There's a reason. A double sledgehammer in the rib cage. Another one on the side of the rib. Lying knee drop. Right in the small of the back. Jim Mitchell, referee. I guess now, because Bockwinkel's leg's out on that bottom rope. Call for the break. Is that it? Don't trust Bockwinkel. He's got something up his sleeve. Oh, well, maybe not. Martel, double sledging him, and a kick in the back, a kick in the scapula, the shoulder blades, the rhomboids, trapezius, he's got them all. All right, 1-2, and Bockwinkel got that right shoulder up and got out of it. Remember, this is for the World Heavyweight Championship. The AWA held by Mick Bockwinkel, the champion. Martel wants it. It means lots of scratch, baby. Lots of scratch. Lots of prestige. There comes the body slam. Oh, and Bockwinkel. Latin. I'll tell you, Heenan doesn't want Bockwinkel to lose. If he does, there goes his meal ticket. 1-2. Oh! He almost lost the whole works right there. Oh, the octopus, a submission hold. Martel has Bockwinkel all tied up. Bockwinkel shaking his head no. Heenan screaming some instructions across the ring. Now Heenan up into the ring, gets the referee over there. And Bockwinkle able to swing that left hand around, and I think he got Martel in the eyes. He's going to throw him right out of the ring, and the referee's arguing with Heenan. Oh, Martel comes back in. Bockwinkle went over. Wait a minute. Just a cotton-picking minute. The referee rings the bell. Listen.
Recently, ladies and gentlemen, I confronted the incredible Hulk Hogan about the possibility of his returning to action in the AWA. Listen to this.
I've got to ask you point blank. Does this mean that you are coming back to the AWA or are you gone?
There's no way, Mean Gene. I gave my word and I will not be back. But you're talking about life. You know, an act of nature, a lightning bolt hitting me and knocking me out. I could handle that. But something like Nick Bockwinkle and Bobby Heenan, people that I know about, I have their M.O. of, I should have had a control all the time. There's nothing I can do about it now. I gave my word, and that's the way it stands. But one thing has changed. My goals in my life have changed. Bockwinkle and Heenan and the AWA ruined everything that I stand for. So, Nick Bockwinkle, I might as well ruin your life, too, and I'm going to be following you everywhere you go.
I don't know what that means, nor...
Wally Carbo, I know that you, as television matchmaker of All Star Wrestling, various promoters around the country, as you told me last week and you told our vast television audience, you tried every means conceivable to encourage the incredible Hulk Hogan to get back into the action in the AWA. It did not work. You resorted to one thing. You said he felt that he let the fans down by not capturing the coveted World's Heavyweight Championship. Now, petitions coming in. I want you to bring us up to date on those petitions.
And I will say this. All those petitions, I can't imagine that there would be so many of them. And I want to thank the people, and I want the people, the wrestling fans, to still send in petitions that haven't signed any to let us know how they felt about the Hulk. Hulk believes that he let the fans down. He did not leave the fans down, according to the volume of these petitions that we have received from the fans.
And Wally Carbo, they are coming in, as I understand, virtually by the thousands. Response like we never anticipated. And I'm certain that is going to have some kind of an influence on Hulk Hogan's decision as far as returning to the AWA.
Well, when all these petitions are in, we're going to gather them and go and confront the Hulk and say, here, Hulk, here's how the people feel about you. They want you back.
All right. Get those petitions into us right here, care of this station, on All Star Wrestling. Thank you, Wally Carpenter. Clawmaster Baron Von Raschke, a native of Nashville, Tennessee. He is Dave the Redneck Schultz.
Hold it right there, baby. Redneck. Redneck. Everybody's hollering redneck. All the fans are hollering redneck. I'm not no redneck, baby. I'm Dr. D. You know what a redneck is, all you people in the Windy City, baby. You know what a redneck is. That's a truck driver runs down the road, got his arm out the window because he ain't got no air conditioning, and he's got a truck driver suntan. He's a farmer that goes out in the fields and plows from sun up to sundown riding a John Deere tractor and gets his neck all red from the sun, baby. I ain't got no redneck, and I don't like it. I want to tell you people, don't call me redneck. Now, this guy comes out here holding his hand like he's got a claw, like he's going to do something to the doctor. Let me tell you something, big boy. If the doctor wants to go out, if he wants his head squeezed until he passes out, I can go to the doctor downtown and get something that'll put me out. Now, I'm going to put these mamas right here around you, baby. I'm going to put these mamas around that neck, and I'm going to squeeze you until your
all
head
right.
pops.
If I may, I can live with Dr. D. Dave Schultz, let me say this. I know about your reputation in various parts of the country, even up in Canada. But here is a man, a seasoned veteran, and Baron Von Raschke. What about your credentials? I want to hear about your past.
Maybe I could sit out here. It'd take me 24 hours on this national TV to run it down, how many championship matches I had, how many belts I've held. And it'd take me all day long, and I ain't got that much time. But I'm 6'5", baby, 260 pounds of blue twisted steel and sex appeal. and I'm a rich woman's lover and a poor girl's dream. So all you poor women out there, just keep dreaming on, baby, because you can't bother the doctor.
All right.
Waiting for the Baron, baby. You bring the claw on, and you try to put the doctor down.
All right,
down.
Chicago.
They've tried before, baby. It ain't never been done.
Thank you, Dr. D, Dave Schultz, whatever, the man that is going to be testing Baron von Raschke here in Chicago this coming Saturday night at the University of Illinois Chicago in the pavilion. Get your tickets in advance. Number of new international stars arriving in the AWA, one of which happens to be the man to my immediate left, the finest out of the Orient, Mr. Saito from Tokyo, Japan, a man who incorporates the martial arts along with a great amateur background, making one of the best in professional wrestling. Rock and roll Buck Zumhoff, your opponent here this coming Saturday night in Chicago.
Zumhoff, just like a short, skinny, bad lizard. Just like American car. You know American car?
American car?
Yeah, just like American listeners. You know, Japanese listeners, just like a Toyota car. You are strong, tough, mean. You know, Japan, everything great. Camera, TV, watch, everything.
Wait a minute now. If I may interrupt, Mr. Saito, I am aware, correct me if I'm wrong, but did not one of these soft American wrestlers, the incredible Hulk Hogan, recently defeat in Japan the Japanese champion Antonio Inoki?
What?
Dick Bockwinkel.
Well, you know, Gene, I made a lot of predictions, and a lot of them come true, and a lot of them haven't. But this is one that I really believe will come true. You know, Heenan's screaming about Hulk Hogan going to be there. Well, you know, that's the American way. If you've got the money, you can buy a ticket. You can go anywhere you want to. Now, if Hulk Hogan wants to buy a ticket and set ringside, that's his business. The thing is, they'd better start worrying about me and not Hulk Hogan.
Absolutely.
Because I'm the man they're going to have to get in the ring with. I'm the man that they're going to have to defeat wrestling. Now, I don't know where Bockwinkel is. I see Heenan out here screaming. And Bockwinkel should take care of the men. And he should try to get even for what I did to him, because Heenan has helped him many times. But I want to tell you one thing. I said I was going to be the first American Indian to be the world's champion, and that's exactly what I mean. You know, Bockwinkel says he's mentally down. Well, that's fine, Bockwinkel, because I'll take the belt any way I can. Put the pressure on me. I can stand it. And then go take you a long vacation, because I'd love to be the world champion.
Many Wahoos say he is ripe for the picking in light of what happened last week with Brad Ringens in front of a national television audience and the incredible Hulk Hogan recently. Saturday night, big one for you. I thank you. Wahoo McDaniel challenging Nick Bockwinkel at the pavilion. Just seeing the man, Nick Bockwinkel, who is going to be challenged this coming Saturday night here in town by, of course, Wahoo McDaniel, a gentleman I talked to just a little bit earlier. Up in Milwaukee, fans, for the people of Milwaukee, Saturday night, July 30th, 8 o'clock, Milwaukee Auditorium, big all-star wrestling card, being, of course, put together by promoter Dennis Hilgart for the great fans in the Milwaukee area. Here in town this coming Saturday night, 8:30 p.m., University of Illinois Chicago Pavilion at Harrison and Racine, plenty of good seats available. By the way, 5 minutes from the loop, plenty of great convenient parking, and a spectacular all-star wrestling card put together by promoter Vern Gagne. Sheik added on L. Casey, Ken Patera, gentlemen, Jerry Black. Where is Jerry Black?
Don't you have to worry about His Highness. He's been receiving by His Excellency, my good friend Muammar Gaddafi, by King Fahd of Saudi Arabia, by King Habib Bourguiba of Tunisia. He's having such a good time. He's going berserk, the guy. He's never been so happy.
Sheik, if I can interrupt, he better be back on Saturday night. Six-man tag team action with Ken Patera, yourself, and Jerry Blackwell against Great Gagne, Jim Brunzel, and Mad Dog Vachon.
Don't you worry about His Highness. He will be in the ring defending himself, because the doctor told me I don't have to wear the cast anymore because my hand is in good shape. But now they forced me to the match. I must put the cast on back.
Oh, no. Well, that time, certain AWA officials would question a move like that, Sheik.
Now, we're going to get rid of the three men once and for all, because we take a pride in wrestling. My new brothers, the door of heaven is still awaiting for you to go back home. What are you going to do in the three men? Because I'm
right
behind you.
Very good. Ken Patera, six-man tag team action.
I'd like to reiterate on what actually did happen before.
The High Flyers went down in defeat. It was a long, hard, tough battle, but Jerry Blackwell and Kent Patera accomplished our mission, and the belts now belong to the Arab nations, 800 million strong. And I'm going to tell you, High Flyers, there was no return clause.
No way.
So you had to go out and get yourself a partner, a dog, a goon, a hitman. Well, I'm going to tell you something. There's a pine box still circulating somewhere, and all three of you are going to wind up in it.
By the way, back out!
Just a second. La ilaha illallah, Muhammad
bin
Abdullah.
I do not want to get into a verbal confrontation.
Tell me.
I am very curious.
Yes.
The match between Blackwell Patera and the High Flyers up in St. Paul, Minnesota, was videotaped. Strangely enough, I have not been able to get my hands on that videotape.
Well, let me tell you something. This is a past history. People forgot what happened. They want to know now, and they are the tag team champion of the world.
Gentlemen, I thank you. She got it on LKC, Ken Patera, joined, of course, by Jerry Blackwell in six-man tag team action here on Saturday. Seeing Wahoo McDaniel in action, I am very, very impressed. Nick Bockwinkel on a downer as of late. You recall what Brad Ringens did to him, Hulk Hogan earlier. And I can't help but believe McDaniel catching the world's heavyweight champion at the right time. Gentlemen, Greg Gagne, jumping Jimmy Brunzell, if you would come in. I'm certain you've got to agree with me on that note.
Right. Wahoo is a determined athlete, and he's got a tremendous chance to upseat Nick Bockwinkel. And, you know, it's pretty hard for Greg and I to come out here talking about the six-man tag match that we were looking forward to. Well, now we're looking forward to it even more, because Adnan L. Casey, through your interference, Jerry Blackwell and Ken Patera have our belts. And when Gene Okerlund, we were watching backstage, and when you asked him about that videotape, we had heard that the championship committee has that videotape and are viewing it, but we haven't heard the results of their findings right now.
I intend to find out.
Gene, why don't they show that out
right
here? Why don't they show it on national TV? Let everybody see how the Sheiks won the title. And it isn't ironic that as soon as that championship match is over, the cast comes off the Sheik's arm.
But, Greg Gagne, he brought up the possibility of him putting that cast back on for a match.
He's going to have to put a lot of them on when we get done with them. Because our partner last week came out here and bought out Rick Martel, bought his contract to take his place in the match. And that's this man right here. He has the same feeling for Blackwell, Patera, and Sheik that we do. And when we get done with them, there's going to be more than just one cast on one arm. Isn't that right, Mad Dog?
Mad Dog Vachon.
And there's certain things that's more important in the world than money. And that's friendship. And that's why, Ricky Martel, give me the permission. Give me a chance. Get me a favor. Because I can't wait to get back in the ring with Jerry Fatwell, the Sheik, and the trainer, a member of the latest bribe, Ken Patera, after the beating I give Fatwell right here in Chicago. Where is he anyway? Where's that fat slob?
They say he's catching a little R&R back in the Mideast and Baghdad,
you know,
Iraq.
What? It'll be so easy to give those three crooks, that's what I call them, the pile driver after they get drop kicks here from Jim and drop kick from Greg. We're gonna have fun. We're gonna tear them apart. It's gonna be dog eat dog.
You know, Gene, they always talked about before, if they hurt one of us, that the titles would be forfeited to them. That never happened. But on this night, it's going to happen to Blackwell, Patera, and Sheik. And those championships are going to be handed back to us when they can't defend them.
That's right. Adnan L. Casey, you're a marked man.
All right, I thank you, gentlemen. What a trail to draw to in the frame of mind the High Flyers are currently in. And then, of course, the legendary Mad Dog Vachon. Ladies and gentlemen, I do want to remind you, an influx of petitions, they're coming in by the thousands. You, the fans, demanding the return of the incredible Hulk Hogan to the AWA. Speaking of that, these very attractive T-shirts now available via mail order. Here's where to send. Peter Lopresti, All-Star Sports at 7321 42nd Avenue North, New Hope, Minnesota, 55427. $10 handles it all. Shipping, handling, and, of course, the T-shirt. Very attractive. On the back, it says very clearly, bring back the Hulk, the incredible Hulk Hogan.
a newcomer in the AWA out of Nashville, Tennessee, Dave the Redneck Schultz. Dave Schultz, Dr. D.
First thing, baby, it's not Redneck, it's Dr. D. And the real reason the Hawk ain't here, he heard the doctor was coming. You heard the doctor was coming, and you took off. Nick Bockwinkle's not the reason you're not here. You didn't let nobody down. You heard the doctor was coming. Just like everybody else, baby. Gene, everybody's going to be leaving. Everybody's going to be leaving because the doctor, they've got to meet the doctor. And the doctor wants to become number one. And to become number one, you got to go over everybody. You got to beat everybody down. You got to pin their shoulder, and that's what the doctor does best. And everybody calling me a redneck. Baby, you don't call a man a redneck. Driving the finest automobiles in the world, live in the finest hotels in the world, eat in the finest restaurants, wear diamond earrings. You don't call me no redneck. I ain't got no redneck suntan, baby. I have a Las Vegas suntan. I have a San Francisco suntan. I have a Denver, Colorado suntan. I have a lovely suntan. Now, a redneck, somebody goes out here and plows the fields like I told you, Gene. I'm not no redneck, baby.
Well, it was not meant in a derogatory sense, and if you, in fact, prefer Dave Schultz, I'll call you Dr. D.
Dr. D, baby, Dr. D. I prefer that. And I want to tell you something, Hulk Hogan. You go ahead and get all the petitions you want, and you come on back. And when you meet the doctor, baby, you ain't going to have to want people to write in, want you to come back. You ain't going to have to come out and tell people you let them down. They're going to know you let them down because I'm going to drive you down like a 10-penny nail, baby, just like a 10-penny nail, because I know the reason you left. And I'm the reason he left you.
I thank you very much. Here's a man who promises to terrorize virtually the entire AWA. He has recently arrived, pre-recorded, before the big card in town last night. A lot of new faces in the AWA. One of them, my guest at this time, one of the best from the Orient. Come on in, if you would, please. Mr. Saito from Tokyo, Japan. Oh, Mr. Saito, that is an absolutely gorgeous smoking jacket.
Oh, thank you very much. That's a beautiful kimono. Look at that. All silk and gold, too. Lot of expense, lot of money.
It does look very, very rich, and I must compliment you on your attire. You know, you have compared the American wrestler to the Japanese wrestler, and you have stated that you feel the American wrestlers are soft. Is that true?
That's true. American wrestlers are very soft. I be so easy them. You know, Mr. Saito, Japan wrestler number one. We know master, judo, karate, wrestling, everything. Just like a fighting machine.
You know, I'm very curious. You say the Japanese wrestlers are so very good. They're strong, they're tough, they're durable people. As far as a diet is concerned, I'm very curious, what kind of food do you eat?
Well, we eat the sukiyaki, tempura, osashimi. They also eat fish head.
Fish
head makes smart.
Did you say fish heads?
Right, fish head.
Well, now, how are they prepared? Cooked or raw?
So raw. You try one. You more smart.
Well, I don't know if that really sounds that appealing. Nonetheless, you're here in the AWA. You've been very impressive. Brad Ringens, we just had to show that again. Nick Bockwinkle is the world's heavyweight champ, really being tested as of late by Brad Ringens, Rick Martel, Wahoo McDaniel, and the incredible Hulk Hogan. And by the way, I might remind you, fans of Chicago and this entire area, those petitions coming in by the thousands, I think that's what it's going to take to convince the incredible Hulk Hogan to return to action here in the Windy City. In conjunction with that, beautiful T-shirt, the incredible Hulk Hogan, can be ordered by mail order. Here's what you do. Send to Peter Lopresti. Speaking of Peter Lopresti, his father, one of the great ones many years ago with the Chicago Blackhawks, a great defenseman. Send to Peter Lopresti, All Star Sports, at 7321 40.
I want to start a campaign. Start sending letters and a petition to keep Hogan out of the AWA and away from professional wrestling. He showed you what kind of a man he was. He's a quitter, and he left.
Oh.
Now, I'm sick and tired of every time I go someplace and somebody watches TV, they see a tape match of Brad Ringens and Nick Bockwinkle, the intensive care unit. So you better keep your lip button, punk.
Bobby Heenan and I want to point out the interviews we are conducting at this time, pre-recorded before the big card in town this past week. Blackjack Lanza, yourself, I'm very curious. You're here, but where in the world is Nick Bockwinkle?
Never mind where Nick Bockwinkle is. He's a heavyweight champion of the world. When he has time on his hands and he has free time, he does what he wants to do in private. You know, this town here, he sings, "Take Me Out to the Ball Game," right? Sounds like feeding time at Lincoln Park Zoo.
Then you got another guy here, Merv Donahue, the guy with the...
Bill Donahue.
What's the difference? Is that his real hair? It looks like Davy Crockett's hat without a tail. You want to interview some people? Interview Mike Ditka. Interview George Allen. Those are losers. Interview Ernie Banks. He's retired. I don't know what he's doing right now. Who cares? Then you got a bunch of the Chicago Bulls. They're
at Chicago, the University of Illinois, Chicago, at Harrison and Racine in the pavilion. Listen to this. It's going to be Jerry Blackwell, Ken Patera, new tag team champions, title defense, and they're going to be meeting Rick Martel and his partner. I've asked Martel who the man is. He has been very tight-lipped about it. Hopefully, we can find out more today. Brad Ringenstein to meet Mr. Saito. Rednick, Dave Schultz to meet High Flyer Jimmy Brunzell. Bill White, the Rebel out of South Carolina, to meet Greg Gagne. And Baron Von Raschke also signed on that card. Wahoo McDaniel, you signed to meet Blackjack Lanza. And this city of Chicago has really, over the past couple of months, been something for you.
Well, it's been a good place for me, you know, and I think me being signed with Lanza, you know, I'm not through with Bockwinkel yet. And Bockwinkel, if I didn't know better, I think you'd have a little to do with that. When I got Heenan, everybody was going to come beat up the Indian for beating up Heenan. Smashing his face in the post, everybody's going to jump on the Indian. We're going to get even for you, Heenan. We're going to take care of that Indian where he never bothers any of the family again. Well, you know, when they started jumping on me, 6'1", 265 pounds, they found it was a lot easier to jump on than it was jump off. Now they got the big Texan coming after me. Well, Lanza, you come on, because I tell you one thing, he's no stranger to me. And I know he's going to try to get rid of me. I know he's going to try to hurt me because he is part of the family. Well, Lanza, you'd better go to the gym. You'd better start doing some push-ups, leg-ups. You know, the man took a little vacation. And for 3 years, I haven't seen him. And now he's back. Well, let me tell you something. While you were on your little vacation having a good time, I was out there in the ditches digging it out, brother, wrestling all over the world, wrestling everybody I could to try to get better. Well, I don't think I'm to the place now. I don't have to get any better. I just have to do what I want to do right now the best way I can do it. So, Lanza, I'm saying, when you get in the ring with me, don't make any promises to Heenan and don't make any promises to Bockwinkel, because you know, sometimes when you step in a ring with a man of my caliber who's a little high-strung.
To this resounding applause, Hulk Hogan. Hulk, come on back if you would. Hulk Hogan, our camera's here. Hulk, you're here with us at this time, and I'd like to know, quite candidly, does this mean you're back in the AWA?
You know something, Mean Gene? Everybody flew me, the AWA flew me here for the special presentation because of what happened in Tokyo, Japan, and I'm glad to be here, and I'm glad to see all my people here, but... like I said, Mean Gene, I will not change my mind. I will not come back and wrestle here in the AWA.
Well, now, Hulk Hogan... Hulk Hogan, a lot of people have been asking me if and when you would come on back to finish the mission, so to speak, and someday become the world's heavyweight champion.
You know something, Mean Gene? Everybody knows how I feel, and everybody knows I'm a man of my word, and there's no way I will come back, but I will ruin Mr. Bockwinkel's life. I will fall him to the ends of the earth, and I'm going to drive him crazy.
How about that, ladies and gentlemen? Now for the special presentation from the Japanese Wrestling Federation and Mr. Saito to the incredible Hulk Hogan. First the flowers, and then the trophy. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you very much. All right, how about a big hand? That presentation to the incredible Hulk Hogan. Thank you.
And the flowers from Mr. Saito for the championship he won in Tokyo, Japan. And now, suddenly, Mr. Saeed and Rock and Roll Zumoff is in the ring. Mr. Saido throws the light heavyweight champion of the world out of the ring. Mr. Saido takes off his kimono, and he is now going to go after the Incredible Hulk Hogan again. Oh, no! No! We have got to get this thing stopped here. Mr. Saido has gone wild in the ring with the Incredible Hulk Hogan. In comes Greg Gagne. In comes Ricky Martel. Brad Langens is in there. Oh, my heavens, what in the world has happened here? Mr. Saido taking a bow for all of this. Oh, no. Wally Carbo tells him out, out, out. As you can see, the Incredible Hulk Hogan, a mass of blood in the ring. Oh, my goodness, ladies and gentlemen. Martel, Rangens, and Gagne. And the Clawmaster, Baron Von Reiske, all in the ring, trying to help the Incredible Hulk Hogan, who announced just moments before that he would not return to the AWA, and then all of a sudden, after receiving the flowers and the trophy from Mr. Saido, all of a sudden, Mr. Saido goes crazy and drives the trophy to the head of the Incredible Hulk Hogan.
The Incredible Hulk Hogan split open by that devastating blast by the base of that trophy that was to be awarded to him. And of course, Mr. Saito was to be the official emissary of the Japanese Wrestling Federation. This kind of violence in the AWA, I've got to shake my head. I really can't believe it.
This cannot continue. There's going to have to be some very, very severe action.
Hey, let's get on the air, ladies and gentlemen, ladies, I cannot believe what has happened here. Hulk Hogan on the head with this, split him wide open. Hulk Hogan being taken down to the locker room to be attended to by paramedics. Wally Carbo, somebody come on up. Bobby Heenan. You happen to be standing by. You saw what happened. Of course, I don't know what could possibly come over a man like Mr. Saito to do what he did
here. Well, as far as I'm concerned, Hulk Hogan got exactly what he deserves. You know, he's won the championship of Japan. He's been gloating about his big victory over Inoki. It just shows you how tough he is.
Get me Mr. Saito. Get me Mr. Saito, ladies and gentlemen. Get me Mr. Saito. Wally Carbo, it is all broken loose in the studio. People, just the look of disbelief on so many faces. Ladies and gentlemen, we will keep you apprised of the condition of the Incredible Hulk Hogan. I can't believe it.